Let's get the show on the road. Good morning. Welcome to the Opie and Anthony Show.
And it's Monday.
Quickly look at the David Carradine death photo because they're going to be getting rid of that immediately.
It's hard to get rid of stuff off of the inner tubes.
Yeah. True.
So, you know, if they take it off of there, it's already out. So people just right-click and save it, put it on other shit. So there it is. We just were looking at it. It's a nice Monday morning thing to look at.
A nice morbid way to start another week of radio.
Dead Kung Fu.
The photo is not that great.
Nah, it's nothing, you know. It's not like, oh my God. You can't see his face. It's taken from the back. I think the door or something is kind of blocking half of the body. A lot of room, so it's not like a close-up on him. But pretty sick. A little sick. I've seen so much worse on the internet. It's not like anything's shocking. Years ago, that would have been like, oh my God.
Of course it would have.
Now it's just like, what about the close-up on the face with the, you know, purple lips and the fucking, you know, the rope tied around the genitals.
But his hands are tied above his head, right?
Yeah, it looks
like. That's a little weird.
His hands are bound above his head, which is like, how do you do that by yourself?
Unless somebody else was in that room.
Yeah, that's what.
And maybe things went awry, and this person said, fuck this, I'm out of here.
The old 23 Skidoo out, right. Out the door. Apparently some divorce papers were got out that said his ex-wife was saying that one of the things that she was complaining about was his unsafe sexual practices. So he was a dirty, dirty boy, apparently. And this might have been one of those things where he liked doing stuff like this. And, oops.
How bad do you need to get off, though?
It just becomes one of those things. You like doing it, I guess. You like
yeah,
doing it.
Just seems complicated.
All right. Really does.
I need a rope around my genitals. All right. Where am I going to put that rope? Where can I hang my hands?
Or have rope? Where can we get rope?
Right.
It is a big production, isn't it?
It really is.
Tie me a sheep shank.
We have to go to the hardware store to...
Oh, that didn't take
hard
long.
War stare, hardware.
I'm tired.
Hardware stare.
I wanted to say hardware store.
Of course you did. What else could you have wanted
but
to
do? You just said Worcester, I think.
Hardware stare.
Worcester. Worcester.
How do they get the death photo there, Steve, before they get rid of that?
This one is on iReport.com.
Ah.
And,
oh, that's easy.
Yeah.
That's easy for everybody. iReport.com.
I or E-Y-E?
I. Okay. iReport.com.
The letter I, not like the eyeball.
Yeah, but it's in the paper today, the family outrage that photo's out there, so most of these sites will get rid of it.
It is a little outraging, if you're the family, I would gather.
Yeah.
But, it seems to be one of those sexual things gone awry and not so much a he wanted to kill himself thing.
And Rob Schneider was on CNN last night basically saying he there's no way he would have killed him. They're still playing that angle.
How does Rob Schneider know him?
Maybe they were doing a movie together or something. I don't know.
Oh, then maybe he was killing himself. Jesus. Careers in the shitter.
But, yeah, they're still going with that angle. He would never kill himself.
Yeah.
We know. It's becoming pretty obvious what he was doing.
Yeah. There's a... dirty little monkey, wasn't he?
And he made a bit of a mistake, a miscalculation.
Yes, dirty ass.
So we got that picture to check out. A video I didn't see because guess what? I don't watch the Tony Awards.
Who does? Oh.
Who came in here? Half the staff all excited.
I saw it.
Yeah, half the staff comes in here all excited. Did you see the Tony Awards last night?
No.
Why would we see the Tony Awards? And watch what the play Billy Elliot win stuff. Who cares?
Oh, yeah, no wonder the three kids that play Billy Elliot won a Tony Award.
A combined Tony,
yeah, combined Tony, of course.
But there what
the judges were probably drooling over the young hairless little boys. Stop it!
But there is a reason to watch the Tony Awards last night.
Oh my God!
Our pal Brett Michaels, who's done this show many times. Pretty much knocked himself out last night.
He got knocked the fuck out.
Was he all right after this?
The his camp isn't saying anything, but the Tony spokesperson said that he just missed his mark and he's fine. But
why was Poison opening up the Tonys?
Yeah,
last
that's a good question.
That's a little weird to begin with.
Rock of Ages.
Rock of Ages.
Thank you. Okay.
That makes sense.
The Rock of Ages doing very well on Broadway. So you get Poison. Were they singing Nothing But a Good Time?
Yeah, that was what they were. It was a part of a long 10-minute long opening number.
And then
he has to be a ham is what happened. He wanted that last bit of stage time to stand in front while all the other musicians were getting off of the stage and kind of onto the drum riser to the back.
Yeah, they were pushing backwards.
This giant fucking
block
NHL scoreboard size thing is being lowered down. And he's like at the front of the stage still going like, hey. And then he turns around to walk back with the rest of the band. But this thing got too low. And I guess his cowboy hat brim blocked his view. He's skipping and it smacks him. It comes down and he runs right into it pretty much. He skips face first right into this giant piece of scenery.
Was he knocked out by that?
I don't know, because it stops right there. Did the thing squish him? Is Bret Michaels alive today? Oh, do we know that great. Much?
He is. He's around. He's obviously in town. I put words out to his guys to get him to see if he'll call in.
I want to see other camera angles, because the main camera cut right away and went somewhere else.
Yeah, why?
Which, again, why wouldn't you just show that and get some laughs?
They probably panned to people laughing.
But there's, you know, there's a fuckload of cameras during those things, so I can't wait to see the footage that finally comes out.
The video's going to do very well today.
Where he just hits the floor.
We're trying to get someone from his camp to call the show.
Yeah.
I'm sure he's all right.
Yeah, if he wasn't, I mean...
But look what we missed, because we didn't watch the Tonys.
The Tonys! That's the one you just don't watch unless, you know, you're a
why
little...
Why would you?
If you're a little... Yeah.
For
you know
real,
I mean?
Why would you watch the Tonys? I'm trying to think if there would ever be a reason to watch the Tonys.
You know what the odd thing about the Tony is, as opposed to the Grammys, the Emmys, the Oscars? Take the Academy Awards, if you will. It's something that a lot of the nominated movies and stuff people have seen.
Mm-hmm.
You see, like, a lot of the movies. You might miss a few, but for the most part, Grammys, you've heard the songs. Emmys, you've seen the TV shows,
mm-hmm.
or at least you know about them. The Tonys, it's like, who goes to all these shows and is sitting there going, oh, let me see, oh, who's going to win Best Actor? And I'm musical, oh, Best Revival, oh, Guys and Dolls. Yeah, it's like, who can? No one has seen it all.
It's
so you sit there going, I don't know what this is. I don't know who this is. I don't care.
It looks like an award, any other award show, but you don't know anyone.
But you don't know one goddamn person. That's exactly why no one gives a shit.
And if you do take a peek, these people will go on stage to get their award, and everyone is like, of course he should have won.
I can't believe.
They all know the person, and it's really just... Gives a shit.
And the winner, Bruce Mitchelson. Oh my God, I knew Bruce would win. When Bruce Mitchelson got up and won, I said, what?
And you're at home scratching your head. Who's Bruce?
Who is that?
Who is this guy?
You don't know who.
Was he ever in a movie?
Yeah.
Let me look at my IMDb. All right. Second bartender in.
Can you name one person in Mamma Mia or in any big
Holy
play that's
shit,
out?
Are you kidding me?
Except like when Broderick or Nathan Lane do them.
Yeah. When you get the gimmick guys in, or, you know, Broderick and Nathan Lane, of course, they've done a lot of the musical comedies and things.
Yeah, I was going to say, I know one person on Broadway, Nathan Lane. Just got to assume he's in something.
Yeah, he's in something.
He's got to be. All right. Hey, speaking of movies, Land of the Lost. First bomb of the summer, my friends.
Isn't actually a guy?
You found Bruce Mickelson?
Bruce Mickelson.
Oh, close enough.
Yeah.
Flesh Gordon.
Land of the Lost is the first bomb of the summer movie season.
And what a surprise, Opie, because from the trailers and everything, I was thinking, this looks hysterical.
Oof.
And it's based on a show that was so well done, so well received, and very mature. Do they think, like, just dredging up old crap and redoing it means a hit?
Well, it was a trend for a while, and it did very well, but I think it's time to move on from that and start getting some original projects made again.
Original what? Like someone actually writing something
new? Yeah, they got lazy in Hollywood. Yep, the Land of the Lost is a sign that they got to move away from just remaking every single old TV show.
If you look at the original show, the guy who played the dad in Land of the Lost, he's the creepiest looking guy in a sitcom ever.
Yeah.
Steve, can you find him? I don't mean to interrupt you while you're texting. Can you please?
As he finds that, I got to tell you, I never watched Land of the Lost. I watched one episode of that thing.
It's the worst show ever.
So why would you remake it?
The opening sequence
That's pretty good. That's realistic.
Is so bad. They're rafting and somehow get sucked down this river, which is a little stream of water that has to be 2 inches wide with them superimposed horrifically in it.
Well,
and then the dinosaurs are claymation.
That show costs $40 an episode to make.
And I think Jimmy said it last week. Why would you make a dinosaur movie after Jurassic Park? What are you trying to accomplish?
Yeah.
Because even... I know they've gotten even better with special effects, but you watch that Jurassic Park, it still freaking holds up.
That T-Rex holds up, man.
It still holds up.
Looks great.
I'm going to get Steve to YouTube the opening scene so you can see it all, but if you've never seen it, it's really bad. The song is really catchy and good.
The song is horrible. The video, just ridiculous.
I want this stuck in people's heads, though. The last part.
Yeah.
Land.
Oh, here it is.
Marshall, Will, and Holly.
Marshall, Will, and Holly.
On the routine expedition. At the greatest earthquake ever known.
Oh, God. Look at how horrendous this is. Oh, my God.
It struck their tiny raft.
Then they fall down a waterfall. Of course, it's Sid and Marty Krofft.
To the land of the lost.
They probably thought that looked really good for the time, you know?
I think they did. Ah, look at the dinosaur.
He looks like a half a wet duty.
To the land.
And what kind of routine expedition is the father, son, and a daughter?
Well, there's a camera involved.
Thank God they found that cave at the end.
Yeah.
And then the T-Rex comes after the camera.
Opie, do you know who Chaka is?
I mean, just because I've been around, you know, Earth for a while. You know? I never searched out that show when I was growing up.
That little piss stream they were going down in the draft.
Amazing.
It's awful. Like sperm.
Yeah,
like
amazing.
They couldn't have found a little more water.
That was like a Vaz Deverns. Is that what the cockman is called?
The Vaz Deverns. That's where the semen comes through, the sperm swim through.
I love a good Vaz Deverns reference.
Vaz Deverns.
It's a great movie star name. Vaz Deverns in.
Did you see Vaz Deverns on the Tonys?
Yes.
Fantastic.
He won for Coming Home.
Number one movie at the box office. Anyone want to guess? Close race this week. Close race.
Number one. It's not Zach Galifianakis' movie, is it?
Land of the Lost.
That's doing well.
The Hangover is a hit.
Yep.
Yeah.
I can't tell you how many people said, holy shit, you got to see The Hangover this weekend.
Really? Because the trailer looked a little too goofy.
I thought so too, Ann.
I was like, all right, it's goofy.
The reviews are really good, and word of mouth is really good on The Hangover. I mean, really good. And it came in second.
Second?
Yes. It did $43.2 million. That's real good. But I think the word of mouth
how
is going to give it 43.2, but it's got a nice word of mouth. I bet you the next week is going to do just as well. It'll be right up there, the numbers.
Yeah, I wouldn't have gone and seen it because
the trailer was shaky, right?
Yeah.
But they're saying there's a lot of funny scenes in that. Up, number one again.
Oh, the old...
That looks really good, but Jimmy doesn't like the cartoons.
Which one?
I like to still call them cartoons.
He puts the balloons on his house?
Yeah, the old guy putting the balloons on his house.
Old guy, balloons on his house.
And then he goes on a little adventure.
Got balloon hands. Fucking balloon hands.
Yeah, fuck you.
Fuck you.
Wait, go for a ride. Fuck you.
No way, no how.
No way, no how. Balloon hands.
Dude, that balloon hands.
That guy is so funny.
You can't not. His voice is wonderful. It's soothing. It's funny.
Yes.
It's sexual.
He never gets very upset about what he's talking about. It's just get out of here.
Get out of here.
Come on.
Fuck you.
When Bill described it, Bill Burr turned us on to that, and I was like, it didn't sound good, but when you watch that fucking gecko or whatever it is, it's perfect.
Yeah, the animation
really, really perfect.
Drinking out of cups.
Drinking out of cups. Fucking stay. What was it? The walking.
Oh, that's my favorite part.
That is my favorite part.
I got to memorize that part. leading me into the building. Fuck you.
Fuck you. Fuck you. That's where the fuck you comes from.
How did the whatchamacall? How many money did Land of the Lost
stay
make?
Right there, man. The third one down.
How much did Land of the Lost?
Oh, I thought it was athletic supporters.
No, that's not it.
Drink.
That's in response to. I hate those.
No, it's not what I thought. Did you hit the third one down?
Yeah, that one right there.
Oh, you did? All right, I'm sorry.
What?
Maybe it's that one?
That one.
Maybe it is.
Mm-hmm. What is this guy think? He's an Indian?
An Indian.
What is he, a goddamn asshole? What the fuck is he doing? Not ever. No way.
I love this guy.
Not ever.
Now he's Johnny Hammersticks. I'm running away like he's friggin' Tommy Noble. What the hell is he doing? Thinks he's got it going, bossing over. No way. No way. What is this garbage? What is this? Oh, I'm king of the trees. I'm the tree meister. I count on them. Well, sometimes I pry, I like to steal. Yeah, right. This guy's a faggot. This guy's some sort of faggot Indian in the teepee. Ooh, this guy thinks he's Captain Knots. Thinks he's Captain Tying Knots. When everyone needs some knots tied, they go to him. Bullshit.
Bullshit.
Bullshit. This woman's such a bitch. Thinks he's Miss Sand. Drinking out of cups.
Ups.
Being a bitch.
Ups.
I bet her fist. I bet her fatalesque burned. Pat our scum, pat a little kid in the background, fucking going crazy. Who's this guy? Mr. Balloons. Mr. Balloon Hands. No way. No way. Get real. Like those things. Mr. Walkway. Mr. Walk Down Me, I'm the walkway. Lead me to the building. Fuck you.
Just trying to help.
643. Yeah, right. You some stupid bitch. Who paid for that floor? Not me. No way. Never paid for no floor ever again. Not once. Not never. Nope. Whose chair is that? Who bought that goddamn chair? That's not my chair. Not my chair. Not my problem. That's what I say. No way. Stupid dresses. Stupid flowers. Lighthouses rule. You don't like the lighthouse? You suck. What is this, seahorse captain?
Captain.
What is this, seahorse seashell party? Who didn't invite me? Why didn't I get invited, seahorse seashell? What is this? Get real. I'm in love with seahorses. I'm in love with them. They're so beautiful and cute. I'm in love with the seahorses. They're fucking unreal. I love them. They're like all the clocks. I love them. I love seahorses, and I love looking at them, and I love seashells. I love seashell things. I love things with seashells and seahorses on them, like blankets and towels and little bags. I love them. Seahorses. Forever.
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 It just sounds like he is... He's probably in the closet seeing things, but it sounds like he's loving the way the words feel coming out.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
From cups.
Cups.
Like this certain way he's speaking, it just probably feels right.
The walkway.
Weird
no,
mouth.
No way.
Leading me toward the building.
Not once.
Fuck you.
Not never.
My favorite new part. Little kid going crazy.
Going crazy. Hey. Who bought that floor?
I like the words he makes up right before little kid's going crazy.
Yeah, he's just coming babbling
Slurns.
Words.
Yeah, yeah.
No way.
Drinking out of cups on YouTube. I think we're a little late to that party, but it's still fine, man.
Oh, come on.
We'll play that one every day for the next 2 weeks, and it'll still
fantastic.
Be good.
Fantastic.
So Up is your number one movie at the box office. Old guy, what, Boy Scouts, Cub Scouts or something, stuck in his house?
Right.
With balloons.
Balloon hands.
Balloon hands.
Balloon hands.
A lot of balloon hands. And, we said The Hangover is the movie to watch, obviously.
Yeah.
And then Night at the Museum. And Star Trek. Star Trek still doing well.
Still cranking it out. What's the grand total on Star Trek?
Man? God, I don't know.
222?
222.
222
so far.
I guess they're going to have to make a sequel, huh?
I think they were working on it already.
Or another prequel or whatever the hell they want to call them.
Yeah.
So there you go.
Yeah, that franchise.
Land of the Lost, by the way, $19.5 million, but they're calling that a bomb. They were hoping for a lot more on that movie.
Unless you're making fucking 35 mil, 40 mil, you're done.
That's $10 million is just because it's Will Ferrell. Like, there are people who just go see anything he does, and that's where $10 million of that comes from.
Got to give props to Will Ferrell. I'm sure a lot of people have seen it by now, but him doing Man vs. Wild with Bear Grylls, anyone watch that yet?
Really? No.
Oh, it's pretty good. They got all the parts on YouTube.
Go one.
Yeah. But Will Ferrell can't even climb a tree.
Really?
They're, like, Bear Grylls, like, has to, you know, kind of climb a tree to figure out, you know, what direction they're going to go
well,
in.
Farrell doesn't seem like he's in very good shape.
Yeah, but
so it's
but climbing a tree.
Yeah, it's just something you
I
always
do. I think
Bear
Grylls was looking at him like, "What the fuck did I get myself into? The guy can't even do something that every little kid could do. You could still climb a tree if you had to, right? It.
Yeah,
that's what I thought.
I'd get up there.
Yeah,
pull myself up.
Yeah, but tree meister.
Trees, climbing trees. Trees. Me? No way. Not once, not never.
And then he counts numbers and says no.
3, 2, 1. No nope. Fucking way.
Yes,
no way.
But it has to be that way.
Bullshit.
But there's no other way to look at that.
No. He's fucked up.
Hey, Ant. NBA Finals, huh?
Yeah, something.
Come on.
Here's
you watched, right? You
Here's
watched?
What I heard. Oh, of course. Here's what I heard on the way in. Something about game two.
Something about game two. Good.
And I'm like.
Good.
No, all I said was, what? Game two?
Yeah.
I thought they were done with this already.
No, it'll.
Enough.
It'll hit. excuse me. It'll hit middle of June by the time this is over.
I am so fucking sick of basketball playoffs. They go way too long.
And you know that basketball.
Way too fucking long.
And basketball starts up in October. So,
yeah.
So these guys who are still in it, you know, there are teams that ended. Stopped playing a month and a half ago, I
think.
2 months ago, maybe, at this point.
It's ludicrous how long fucking basketball goes.
It's ludicrous how all sports go, except for football.
Football's pretty quick, yeah.
In this, you know, day and age,
uh-huh.
It's crazy how long these seasons are.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, everyone's like, you know, attention span is getting smaller and smaller.
It's ridiculous.
Shorter and shorter, I should say. Well, the Lakers won in overtime.
Oh, the Lakers won?
101-96. I couldn't stay up. I tried.
Yeah, I couldn't either. I was trying to watch the game.
Yeah, right.
And, wow.
Yeah, but see, like, you love stuff. I love stuff.
I know.
Jimmy loves stuff.
It's just it. You like the basketball.
Stanley, and drinking from kegs.
Kegs.
Drinking from kegs.
The keg man.
No way. Uh-uh.
Who put this keg here?
Put this keg here. Kegs. Mr. Keg Hands.
How bad do you want to just make your own?
I know. You couldn't possibly have that delivery,
no,
though.
No.
That is too natural.
Yeah.
A perfectly natural delivery. No, I just sat at home because it was...
Why don't you like basketball, for real?
I've said it before. You can't have a... the whole gist of watching a sport is to watch your team score... And go, holy shit, because it's a rare thing. It should be a rare thing that your team scores.
But you don't want it
and
as
you go, yes.
But you don't want it as rare as soccer.
No, no,
soccer's
no, no, no.
Annoying.
Soccer's the other end of the spectrum where you're like, this sucks because no one's fucking scoring the whole time.
Fuck, we just mentioned soccer. Now watch them come out of the woodwork.
You don't understand. Shut up. All right,
any,
I get it.
Any sport where they could go to a commercial while they're still playing, is it worth watching, really?
Tie a Brazilian flag to your hood and like soccer.
They're even admitting that this game is boring. We're going to go and pay some bills. Don't worry, you're not going to miss anything. And they go back. It's still 0-0.
No way.
The field is way too big.
Yeah.
You should be able to get the whole field in one camera angle.
Yeah.
How about that?
Pop it in there. One camera should be able to cover the field. Right?
How about that?
But basketball, they score too much for it to be exciting. When you're watching football and, you know, you got a 5-yard line fucking drive into the end zone like that,
mm-hmm.
you're up edge of your seat. You're going, come on, get the fuck in there.
Right.
And basketball's tunk, 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 funk, 2 points. Tunk, 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 funk, 2 points. Tunk, tunk, tunk. And all right, I'll give them the last couple of minutes. I know it's cliche, but I'll give them the last couple of minutes during a tight game. A lot of fouling going on. You know, that's very important. Get the guy up at the line, try to get that. Whatever. But the whole why am I going to watch from the first fucking quarter? From the first fucking tip-off, I'm going to sit there and go, oh, yeah, he scored! It's boring to me.
Imagine if you had to react like that every time your team scored.
Every time.
You would be exhausted.
Holy shit, and then the other team scores, God damn it! Damn it! You get all mad. It's like, oh, don't worry, there's 100 more of those to go.
10 seconds later, your team scores again.
Yeah, yes! But it's
imagine
just,
you didn't really know the sport. And you're watching for the first time.
Thinking, wow, he did it.
You know, I think you're right.
The whole thing.
I would like to defend that, but the older I get, I think you're starting to be right about basketball.
It's the whole thing. So that's why I was never really able to just get into it.
You know, I love to do if I walk in and the score is like, say, 10-6. I love to just go, is the fourth quarter?
Yes. This game's over.
And they never understand that you're being sarcastic. Like, nah, man, just started. Like, I know, did asshole.
Out of the four main...
Mr. fucking given scores.
Out of the four main sports, TV watching, what order would you put them in?
TV watching, you got to put football first.
Football first.
You got to put football... It's such a fucking brutally exciting game. You get a good football game, man, it's exciting to watch.
You know what?
That's like, it's like an army. You fucking, you know, it's two teams that they're bashing each other's heads in to get past them to get that fucking ball over there. And that is a good game.
And the soccer fans will argue strategy. I mean, you can't argue strategy with football. You see it.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
see it. They're pushing up the field. Oh, they're short. All right, now we got to figure out what to do. All right, now the other team's coming back the other way.
You know, it's
I was going to say hockey to be different, but you know what? I think you're right, Ant. Football, number one sport to watch on TV.
Third and long, and they fucking go for that pass, and guy keeps his toes in the fucking end zone. Whoa! You know,
the ballerina.
That shit's fantastic to watch.
Second sport
to watch on television.
Mm-hmm.
This might be an odd one, but I'm going for hockey.
Very good. That's what
I'm going
I say.
For hockey.
I
it's
go
a fast moving.
Very good.
Very fast moving. Again, if you get a good game, tight game, it's pretty exciting watching. You know, power plays are great. Watching the team trying to fend off the extra guy, shit like that. It's a lot of fun.
But
then I got to go with baseball, which is a little long winded. It's even a good game. It takes too fucking long.
See, I would go basketball, baseball. You're doing baseball,
I'll
basketball.
Baseball, because there are those moments in baseball where it's like you're sitting there for a while, base is loaded, you know, and the pitch, and it's like, okay, tip, but ball, another tip. The guy's just sitting at the plate, and they're like, come on, what the fuck?
Mm-hmm.
And then wham, smashes it out of the park. I'm looking for exciting moments. And those only come at the end of the basketball games. If some team is fucking, you know, in the shitter by 2 points and some guy's able to break out and sink that three-pointer,
well,
that's exciting.
Well, what's brilliant about sports, they're starting to do the fast version of games. Like, you'll watch a Yankee replay or whatever your favorite team is. I'm sure pretty much every city's doing this now. You could watch, like, a Met game or a Yankee game within an hour and a half.
Yeah.
Or an hour. I think it's an hour. Which is, have you checked this out? Like late night or something?
They do it late at night.
I forgot what they call it. It's like Mets Fast Forward or they come, it's a clever name and you get to see your
no way.
The latest game within an hour.
Really?
And they should do the same thing with basketball. Do it like in a half hour.
Well, you know what I like? And do they use this tactic in that, in what you're talking about? When they're showing the highlights of the pitches that are thrown against, like sometimes the batter's up there for fucking, you know, 30 pitches.
Yeah, but you know what?
And it's like, whoosh, whoosh. On the news highlights, they just show whoosh, 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 one after the other.
No, they choose because sometimes a guy at bat for a long time, you know, fouling off, you know, pitchers and stuff.
Yeah,
that's no, I think it's exciting. Not every time, but every once in a while, you do get one of those moments where, you know, it's a nice struggle between the batter and the pitcher.
Yeah.
You know? So they have to choose those. They don't do a lot of those.
Choose wisely.
Hockey's hard if you don't know the sport, though, because you don't know where the puck is half the time. I can't watch hockey because all of a sudden it's just like, they don't score that often.
That little streak, remember?
They tried that. What was it?
That was when they were going for real slap shot.
Didn't they
turn red?
Didn't they get, like, Steven Spielberg or somebody? They got a big Hollywood director.
Industrial Lights and Magic.
To try to figure out how to make hockey more interesting to watch on TV. I forgot who it was. It might have been Steven Spielberg, though.
They started
with the streak thing, which got way too distracting.
Yeah, yeah.
I think they just should change the color of the puck.
Yeah, black is on white, though. Right?
But
it is black on white. That's kind of.
But you make it like fluorescent orange or something, then you know where the puck is at all times. But you know, purists will yell and scream and throw a tantrum.
Plus, it's going so fast, dude. No matter what color, even if you kind of get the idea of where it is,
well,
it's moving.
Well, that brings me to the second part of this question. Now, do the four sports in order of
going
to the game, because I do think it's different.
All right, you're absolutely right, and it is very different, because number one, I'll put baseball.
To go to?
You know why? It's just, if you have good seats, and it's a nice day, That adds to the whole thing. You don't know. If you're watching on TV, that doesn't come into consideration.
Yeah.
But when you're at the game and it's a nice day, you're hanging out, drinking a few beers, you're just watching, you know, you're watching the game. It's fun to be at. I don't know if you want to put it good to be at live to watch the game only or to experience the whole thing of being at the game.
I would have to go hockey.
I don't know.
Hockey is exciting to watch live, man.
Yeah, it is. But the thing is, you're now, you know, cooped up in an arena. You're kind of...
Yeah, I understand. I mean, yeah, there's different philosophies just, here.
There's a great feeling about going to a ball game in a nice park, you know, good seats, good weather.
Well, the reason I don't put football up near the top because I never got a good seat for a football game.
First of all, yeah, there's 8 billion people in the stadium.
And I never could figure out how to get a good seat for
a
football game.
Another thing, I've never been to a football game where I wasn't freezing my fucking cock off. And I cannot take being freezing cold like that.
I think my family, we're down to like 2 generations from now, we'll finally get like season tickets for the Jets. So we're excited about that. Like,
you're really on a waiting list?
My brother is. He's been on a waiting list for like 10 years. And every year he like goes, moved up another 7 slots. So I guess his grandkids will enjoy having season tickets to, you know, the Jets.
I'd probably go baseball, hockey, football, basketball.
Yeah.
And football, the only reason is because of the fucking weather. Sucks an ass. And you never get a good seat. You're always... everyone on the field is this little dot.
Right.
You can't see shit. You don't know what's happening.
No. The announcers make football very, very
exciting. Yeah, you
exciting,
have to. And the camera angles. I mean, now, right, with the cameras they got at home, you might as well just fucking be at home.
Yeah, absolutely.
Nice big screen, high-def fucking television watching a football game like that is better than being at the game.
Football's amazing live, though, man. It's like sometimes you don't know what happened, but just when you see a bomb pass getting thrown, or when you see a guy break it out of the pack, and it's like baseball I love, but it's every pitch, the foul balls. Bum bum ba da bum ba ba da bum ba ba da bum ba ba da. The music,
da, 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 da.
And then one got
charge.
Yeah, hot dogs, hot dog. It's constant noise.
It is constant noise.
There's not a moment of silence.
Just shut up for one.
For one second.
It's true.
Can I not be stimulated?
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome the Westchester Weeblos. The Weeblos are here today. The Boy Scouts of America. And now it's time for the 7-inning stretch. Man, Cotton Eye Joe. Cotton Eye Joe. Ugh.
It's terrible.
And now YMCA has the grounds crew take the... they still doing that at the
Yankee
Stadium?
Yes, I believe so.
Fantastic.
That's tradition.
It's all noise.
So my list would be hockey, football, basketball, baseball.
Wow, baseball last over basketball? Great, here's basketball. Just sneakers fucking making that sound on the wood floor.
I grew up playing basketball, but it's moving down the list every year.
Yeah.
It really is. I think I would have put that number one for a while.
Ate it.
Now it's in third place with the big four. And finally...
Did I put women's gymnastics down there?
Oh, good God. Or, you know what? Women's tennis if that 17-year-old tit monster is playing.
Oh, the big tit monster tennis player? Of course. Hope she didn't have those lopped off yet.
And for you golf fans, Tiger Woods, just an amazing round yesterday, and he wins the Memorial Cup. After shooting 74 in the second round, which is pretty much you shoot a 74 in a PGA tournament... You know, kiss your chances of winning goodbye.
You're done.
He turns around and shoots a 65 yesterday.
He's amazing.
2 birdies to end it.
Going out on a limb saying that?
Yeah, good input.
Well, not as amazing, because he's still kind of coming back from that.
From the injury.
Massive knee surgery.
Which is hysterical.
Reconstructive knee surgery.
What the fuck is this?
Uh-oh, what do we got?
What is that?
Get the fuck out of here. No way, no how.
Uh-uh.
No way, no how.
Bullshit.
Topless gymnast.
Steve C., topless gymnast.
No way, no how.
On the fucking balance beam. Stop it.
Yeah.
Fuck you.
No way.
2D cups.
2D cups.
Wow, that's pretty sweet. Oh, all right.
This is so hot. It's a gymnast It's about topless wearing a thong on the balance beam.
What boobs.
With great natural tits.
She's wonderful.
What is this about, Steve?
I started seeing these clips a couple of years ago. This Russian chick.
And this pesky
really...
one got in the way.
Yeah.
You know what I love about it? She's a Russian broad.
Yeah,
of course she is.
You know what
she
I love about like... the Russian broad who's just has an amazing body? You know she wanted to be an Olympic champion. I want to know when she finally said, ah, fuck my dream.
When those tits got too big. You can't be a gymnast with those tits.
Fuck my dream. I'm now going to do this nude for everybody so guys could jerk off somewhere.
It's fantastic.
How do they get to this, Steve? They're clamoring out there. Clamoring.
Meta Cafe, and just search on topless gymnast.
Meta Cafe.
Yeah. If you just Google topless gymnast, it's one of the top links, actually.
Why do we have to...
Oh, nice dismount. And she puts her hands up, those beautiful natural breastises. She's wearing a thong. Look at that ass.
She's got to do the Olga Corbett, though.
Oh, wait, where she does that.
Remember the Olga... wasn't that one of the clips that started off Wide World of
Wide
Sports?
Wide World of Sports.
With Olga she Corbett pretty much eating her own box.
Yeah, she...
Find that for Jimmy. Too bad she was ugly.
She was laying down...
She had her chin.
On her chest and chin on the balance beam, and the rest of her body was slung over her fucking head.
So wait, she officially would be eating her own asshole.
Eating her ass. Box. Something. They're close enough where she could get to either
Jesus.
One.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Look at the fucking...
Do you know what I was, sometimes I was trying to watch something this weekend.
Oh God. Nice.
She's doing a handstand with her vag.
Oh, wow. Look at
that. Bulging in her little bikini bottoms and her big boobs. I don't know if they're real, though.
How would you like to just... They look very natural.
Yeah, they do.
Right. They look very natural. How would you like to just run by that balance beam with your tongue out and just lick the top of it when she's finished?
I probably think of other things I'd rather do, but...
Fantastic. Well, if you couldn't, you know...
Why would you want to do that?
I don't know. Fucking licking balance beams.
She's not the only one who uses it, Ant.
Right. You know there was a sweaty guy working on his routine,
Thank God guys don't use that thing.
Or do they don't, right? Okay.
I've never seen one. I don't know.
I was on.
Someone is saying, check out her floor exercise, and it's in capital letters, so it's got to be terrific. What, she does all the events? Topless?
I've seen this one, and I've seen one with her on the, what's it called, the parallel bars?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Let me see if I can find it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Very nice.
What? And she's an average-looking girl.
No, she's got a really nice fact body. That she's doing...
Nice boobs.
She's doing gymnastics naked. That's hot.
And Roger Federer wins the French Open.
Federer.
Do you ever watch men's tennis or women's tennis?
No. Really, right? I'm one of those...
I'll go to the U.S. Open every year, though, because that's a nice event to go to.
Yeah.
Walk around and stuff. Nice day out there in... used to be Forest Hills.
Oh.
The tennis center.
Yeah, they don't do it out there anymore? What?
Well, they moved it. They moved the stadium right next to, you know, where Shea Stadium is, City Field. Kind of right next to it, sort of there. Ties Pete Sampras' record with 14 major titles, so that's a big deal in the tennis world this
morning.
Did
someone come running out and grab him or some shit?
Yeah, I thought it was hilarious. Why do we have to take that so seriously? The guy was just having fun.
Well, maybe because when it happened once, a woman got stabbed.
Monica Seles.
Yeah.
Good point, good point.
Maybe that's why.
I love how you could shut me down so quickly.
A little good tense point. About it. I just decided to spend the weekend, it was the anniversary of D-Day.
Yes.
So there were a lot of cool things on the History Channel and the Military Channel. So I was just watching that. Hitler lost again every time I watch it.
Oh, what was his overall record?
I think he was 0 for 1.
In the end, he was 0 for 1.
0 for 1. Unless you count his experience in World War I, which pretty much was a tie. I don't think they really lost that one.
Mm.
Kind of set him up. Set him up well for World War II. But, there's Olga. Little Olga Corbett.
She was butt ugly.
But she was a little sweetheart back then. Everyone loved her. She was ugly. Well, and knew those chicks do not age well.
Well, they gave her ponytails to try to make her look cute.
Yeah.
And it just never worked.
But she was just one of those little impish things that I think people
enjoyed. Nadia Comaneci wasn't much better.
No.
And I had a crush on her when I was growing up.
And they grow up.
And then I'd like...
Look, she's like a rubber band.
Yeah, I looked back at what she looked like and I said, what is wrong with you? Why would you have a crush on Nadia Comaneci out of all the women you could pick?
But you watch some of these older balance beam things and they're a lot different than now. I mean, they're doing fucking backflips on these things.
Now? Or back then?
Now. There, she's just rubber girl. She's just kind of...
Yeah.
What year is this, you think? Like
72?
72.
Oh. Yeah, I'd go early 70s, absolutely.
Who did you watch on the History Channel this
Hitler.
Weekend?
Hitler.
Speaking of Hitler.
Yes.
I was trying to watch the movie Downfall. Is a great portrayal of Hitler. The guy's acting is, and there's a scene where he's yelling at his generals, and I'm like, that's what it was like to be yelled at by Hitler.
Yeah.
The acting was so, it's probably the best acted thing I've ever seen anybody do.
Yeah.
So I went to watch it on YouTube, and there's over 100 versions of it, and every one of them is fucking subtitled with some stupid goof. It's like,
really? Yeah, where I saw the one where he's arguing about his Xbox.
Yeah.
It's really.
And one of them is, I want to see Fedor fight in the UFC.
He's speaking German, so whatever's written down there, you know.
Every one of them is ridiculous.
This morning at 3 a.m., Microsoft started to scan for modifier. Yeah, there it is. It really is. A great movie, by the way.
It is a good movie.
You got it. Just get it on fucking Blu-ray and enjoy.
Is that a good Hitler?
Dude,
I mean, just because you put the mustache on doesn't mean
turn the volume
it's a good
up.
Hitler.
What's his name? Hugo Gans?
That's not him.
Steiner konnte nicht genügend Kräfte für einen Angriff.
Here's the generals telling him the bad news.
Steiner ist nicht erfolgt.
Yeah, like, the war is lost, basically, I think, right?
And this Hitler
he doesn't look pleased?
No, he's not happy. Hitler at the end of his term there is shaking, takes his glasses off, and addresses his general.
The president in Rome, Kaiser, Jorge, Krebs, und Burgdorf.
He boots everybody out except for the four.
Except for his generals.
Who are not going to be talked to kindly.
Who are now looking at each other like, oh boy, this ain't good.
Is this the little wisp of hair he has?
Yeah.
Das war ein Befehl!
How the fuck did this have happened? Why was I not informed sooner?
They're all listening through the door like, oh boy, there's hell to pay.
How dare they ban my console? I had over
2,000 Microsoft points. I bought a Call of Duty theme pack.
Even used arcade games from time to time.
Just listen to his voice, though.
It's...
Feiglinge, Verräter, Versager!
Mein Führer, was Sie da sagen, ist ungeheuerlich.
Die Generalität ist das Geschmeiß des deutschen Volkes.
Throws the pens at the map.
Sie nennen sich Generale, weil Sie Jahre auf Militär...
Rocky Dennis was happier looking at the map than he is right now. But that's exactly what it must have been like to be yelled at by that fucking lunatic.
Oh, here comes Ava. She's gonna calm him down.
Watch his little hands.
He knows what to do with his hands.
Dude, this guy is... It's the best thing I've ever seen anybody do as an actor. It's
Jim
fucking,
Norton as Adolf Hitler. His hands are in his pockets.
Yeah.
Ted Hitler.
Yes.
I don't even dislike you. I don't want to kill anybody. Yeah, he did an amazing... Bruno Gans, that was his name. Bruno Gans. He did an amazing fucking job as Hitler. One of the best Hitlers I've ever seen in a movie.
You've seen a lot of them, too, huh?
Oh, I've seen them all.
Who was the worst Hitler?
Worst Hitler ever?
John Amos.
I was running through my head looking for, like, Dick Van Dyke or something.
He kept calling Stalin Jr. People like, this is not
Junior. Yeah, he did a great job. The story was great, too. It was just, you know, instead of this weird kind of cliched version of the bunker in the last couple of days of Hitler being in the bunker, they really took that kind of gritty, realistic take on it. And that scene where Goebbels and his kids and his wife, you know, they don't want to live without their Führer and without the Reich. And, they pull some shenanigans. Holy shit. Just fucking unbelievable scene.
And people were outraged by this movie because it showed Hitler as a regular man.
As a human being and not the monster that... Well, unfortunately, he was a human being, albeit a crazy one.
But that makes it scarier because the Nazis were not these robots from outer space. They were fucking people who, you know, just became these monstrous barbarians. It's like, it's scarier to think that, like, a guy who you can relate to on some level... is capable of that.
Yep.
Just, you know, he loves his dog. Hitler, I was reading recently, he was a vegetarian, and he did not like eating meat because the methods of killing animals was far too cruel.
Yeah, yeah.
And he hated smoking. He thought it was very rude to ruin someone's air with cigarette smoke. He was like a fucking...
I had no problem ruining a lot of people's air, though.
Oh, of course not with Cyclone B.
Job.
The, when the announcement came out that Hitler was dead, they all pulled cigarettes out in the bunker and just put them in their mouth and light up and just all start smoking. Yeah, great movie. Downfall.
Someone is saying the Downfall mashups on YouTube are terrific.
Yeah, there's a bunch of them.
Oh, so you've seen all this stuff.
Yeah.
Hey, and our pal Ed Asner is the star of Up, and this caller wants to know why we can't get Ed Asner on the Opie and Anthony show.
Wow. You know, I never had a bad experience on this program with Ed Asner. I don't understand.
Technically, that's
I know.
A true statement.
Yes. Yay.
It was me, Rogan. Jimmy, you were there, right?
He hugged me and kissed me on the cheek.
Of course.
Man, love me.
Same.
Jimmy was the problem that day.
And Voss? What? I certainly wasn't. You were the destroyer.
Called you the destroyer.
It was me, Voss, Rogan, and Jimmy having a nice time with Ed Asner. What's the problem?
Nice time.
Obviously, I'm setting up the Ed Asner clip if you got it, Travis. I don't know.
I think Travis has it.
He's a big star. I mean, you know.
The big star!
The movie's number one at the box office for 2 weeks in a row, so.
He's got a hit on his hands.
Want to go to break with the Ed Asner thing? A couple minutes
sure.
long? Who cares? We got 2 minutes. No way, no how. Yes, I say
minutes.
Way.
Bridge to
Ed
break.
Ed Asner.
Yeah.
Cartoon.
Leading us to break.
No
Fuck
way.
You.
No way.
Maritala Mohan.
Come on.
Ted Nightenday. John Amos played Gordy.
You think with the listeners we could have a little contest, come up with a new one?
I don't know. It's hard to do,
If you keep it short, well, we could play a few of them.
That is hard to do. Just lock yourself in a closet, take some drugs, and see what happens.
You know what maybe the bit is? Maybe. I mean, not all these bits are going to fly. We understand that. But you got to throw them out there and see what sticks. Maybe if the listeners come up with a drinking out of cups.
Drinking out of cups.
The O&A version. So they use, like, the O&A characters. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Ted Sheckler.
Yeah. Fuck you.
No way. No how, inventor. Stop it.
And you got Big A and Pat from Menaki and Starker Patty, all the peeps.
There kind of are a lot of things you could work into there.
I'll just throw it out there. If it works and we get a good one, maybe it'll motivate others to do them. Or maybe we should try one.
Fuck you.
Fuck you. No way. Too busy.
Love that, man. It's hysterical.
All right, Ed Asner as we go to break.
Ed Asner.
Opie
and Anthony.
$1,200 a month, electric bill.
That's what I'm rolling.
Wow,
and the summer hasn't even really started yet.
No way. No way. What is this garbage?
Really? Yes. $1,200?
$1,200 was my electric bill this month.
Not me. No way. Not once. Not never.
Well, you maybe not.
I better fist. I better have fatalisk. Burned. Burned. Patted a little kid in the background fucking going crazy.
Burned.
Please play that one more time.
I better have fist. I better have fatalisk. Burned.
Fatalisk.
Patted a little kid in the background fucking going crazy.
I want to learn that whole fucking line. I want to learn every bit of gibberish he's saying there.
If you could spell that made up word, I will follow you on Twitter. I'll follow you on Twitter.
That is a good
I better have fist. I better have fatalisk. Burned. Patterson patted a little kid in the background fucking going crazy.
Something fist. I think he's saying fist and then he goes.
And then fisk. Fislarn.
That just felt good. Fislarn.
Yeah.
That's why Spanish was fun. It just felt good to speak Spanish.
Yeah, speak Spanish.
When you get to roll stuff.
Feels good.
Roll.
Feels good. Yeah, I think the pool pump running always got the electric bill up. But I've turned it, ever since I got that bill over the weekend, I've turned into Mr. Light Switch guy now. Now I'm trying to because I would go to bed and realize, I'm upstairs in the bedroom shutting the big doors, my big vault, my bedroom vault. And I'd look and go, I left, 15 lights on downstairs.
Jesus.
And then I'm going, screw it. I'll turn it off tomorrow. And then the basement now, which is now a whole sporting complex and studio and movie theater and bar.
I wouldn't know.
Has, you open invite.
Oh, yeah. I forgot.
Pat Fumanaki was over.
I know. Trust me, I know.
It was.
I keep tabs.
Opie, how about this weekend?
A lot
coming?
Of hi hats.
Anthony, huh? I don't know if you're around, but how about this weekend
yes.
coming?
Yes.
We go to Anthony's house. Mm-hmm. I'll bring my DVD copy of Kiss Meets the Phantom of the Park.
I'll watch it in the theater.
We'll watch it in the theater. Yep. We'll all have popcorn. We'll yes. all sing along.
It'll be wonderful.
Of course it will.
Yes. See?
Can we have a booze-free weekend with you?
You can.
I actually drank on Saturday.
I had one.
My God, man.
I had one half of a tap Bud Light yesterday.
Really?
I poured it, and I just was drinking it, and I'm just like, you know something? I just had my fill over the weekend.
I drank my ass off.
I was done full up.
Saturday I drank more than I have in a long time.
Were you drunk?
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if I've ever seen you drunk.
Oh, yeah. And then I woke up yesterday, played golf, hungover, 90 degrees.
Played golf, missed the ball hand.
Oh.
Yeah?
It's a little rough to be on a golf course when you're a little hungover.
Hungover?
Oh, my God. Yeah.
Sweat it out.
Forget
what? That's what they tell you.
No way. No way. What is this, garbage?
Yeah, exactly.
You
got to
sweat it out.
Hell
garbage.
No.
Yeah, I think it's the pool pump running like crazy. Like crazy, Jerry. Speaking of the pool, I'm supposed to have some supplemental electric heater going in, which is just going to pump that electric bill way up. But in the meantime, I have a propane heater, but it goes through a lot of propane. I don't have natural gas in my neighborhood, which sucks.
Yeah, that doesn't sound like it would be efficient.
Well, it makes, believe me, Jimmy will beg to differ, but it does make it very fucking hot.
Yeah, but how much? how many oil tankers are coming by?
It would be crazy. It's like
going crazy.
It's like a, but it's a buried submarine, pretty much, in my backyard.
Oh, really?
If it ever went up, it would take out like 12 blocks. But. It heats it makes it very hot, and I don't have to leave it burning.
You like
that
a hot
long.
Pool in the summer
no,
too?
The jacuzzi.
Oh, okay. Well, jacuzzi's you're heating your pool though too, right?
Yeah, yeah. I want my pool heated a little bit.
How much though? Just
a tiny
bit.
Bring it into
the 80s.
I don't
in the
want
summer?
Bring it to the 80s in the summer. I don't want, especially if you're in the jacuzzi. I don't want to jump into a cold pool. I don't like cold. I like just drifting around, feeling like I'm in the womb. So they're installing this heater, this electric heater. And Keith is over supervising. I wasn't there yet. And Keith's like, I just started hearing.
Oh, shit.
And then apparently they ran to their van like the little rascals and just took off.
Really?
Yeah.
No.
So Keith comes back. Yeah. Keith comes back. And it seems one of the gentlemen took a Sawzall and the blade as he was cutting something to install the big PVC pipe in, went right into the coil of the heater, because it's a heat pump. Works like an air conditioner, only backwards. That's mm-hmm. how they work. And hit the refrigerant line.
Oh, shit.
All the refrigerant is just coming out. And I'm told this, and we talked to the guy that owns the place that's installing this. I go, listen, I don't want to see some guy here with a torch and his little fucking soldering thing and his flux and everything else. I want that taken out, and I want a new one put the fuck in. It's been a catastrophe.
Yeah, why are you having so many problems?
Because people
are
incompetent.
Are they partaking in the Guinness and the Bud Light before they do work around
your house? No, I lock that bar up.
Good for you.
I can't tell you the anguish that this pool is putting me through. The equipment works. It's great. It's not. It has nothing to do with the equipment or anything. It's the people that have to come over to do things.
Why do they?
And it's crazy.
When did they make pooling so complicated?
pooling. I know.
Let's call it pooling.
Well, the whole thing is,
you got to think when they started putting pools in, it was just like a hole with throw some water in it.
Well, yeah. Now it's a whole thing. Now I got a remote control
for your pool.
For my pool. It's a remote control.
What the fuck's wrong with
Remember
us?
When people had to go over back by the pumps and the filter and everything and turn valves? Now I press buttons and the valves turn, and then I have the little waterfall that comes out of the jacuzzi.
You could do
pool.
That all with a remote?
Yeah, with a remote.
Oh, that's kind of cool.
And then I have the jets that come out, and then I could get the bubbles. So if you're sitting in the jacuzzi, you don't have to get up and turn valves to make the big bubbles come up and make it hotter or something. You do it all with the remote. Mm. And
You're getting a lot more for your money than I am. Holy crap.
Well, I'm spending a lot of money.
No, you know.
Anthony has $9 in the bank.
And that interest.
It doesn't seem like it, but I've spent my money. It's just different when you live in New York City.
In the suburbs.
What you're getting, what I'm getting for the same money, oh.
But now my electric bill, like I said, $1,200 for the month, and I believe what that is lighting. I believe it's lighting for a certain thing that I like doing after work that I can't talk about. Ixnay. Believe me, ixnay.
Like
everyone
about
knows
stuff that enhances the experience.
Whatever.
We got to teach these guys.
I know.
Is what I'm
thinking. They do have to learn, but they never will.
I think they need to get their learn on.
Dogs are too old. New tricks.
You think? I think they can be learned.
Old dogs ain't going to happen. No way.
No way. No way. This is garbage.
Give them a bone. Ain't going to happen.
And me. No way. Not once. Not never.
Fucking put a biscuit on his nose. Uh-uh.
But they're dealing with a radio show that's very unique and different than every other radio show in this facility. Yep. We really continue the experience long after the show's over.
The show technically never ends.
Right.
There is something going on, whether it's the Twittering going on, whether it's our some type of presence we have on the web, whether it's more extravagant or less extravagant. We do have a web presence. And that goes on all the time.
But they can't pie chart it. That's what scares them. If they could pie chart it, then they would go, do your podcast. Yeah,
exactly.
Keep the Twittering
like
going.
That. You know, it's one of those things. But I think the lighting itself is what is really spinning that meter. Because it's a couple of thousand watts, I think. And the room itself gets blazing hot after a while. And I really think that's kind of been what's taken up a lot of the electricity.
But didn't your mom yell and scream at you your entire existence, turn off the lights?
Yeah.
Because
maybe that's
why
I don't do it.
Now that I'm an older guy, I walk around my place turning lights off all the time. And, you know, I'm lucky enough to be able to keep all the lights on 24 hours a day. But
really?
It's still ingrained in my stupid head.
See, I'm doing it now.
So I walk around.
Ever since I got that bill, now I'm doing it just to see if it's more... It's kind of an experiment. I want to see if it's so much the lights I have on. And now what I do when I leave in the morning, I turn the TV off in my bedroom. I used to leave that thing on constantly. So I'd come home to the sounds of the television.
The sounds of humans.
Of somebody in the house, even if it's just a machine. It's a machine.
Why don't you get little Japanese robots to say, hello, Anthony. We're happy you're here.
That's what I need.
Hey, do we have an update on the neighbors? How much do they hate you these days? Are they reaching out? Are they doing anything?
I had contact with my other neighbor.
Which side? Looking at the house.
Looking at the house?
From
the
street.
Left side neighbor.
But he's the one that doesn't like you.
No. Right side neighbor is...
No, left side neighbor was the guy that came over with the cake and all that?
No. That's right side neighbor.
Right side neighbor did all that?
Yeah. Left side neighbor, I barely see.
Okay.
But
right side neighbor gave up on you after the whole cake.
Yeah,
and stuff.
Yeah, yeah. Right side neighbor gave up on me.
And hasn't talked to you since?
I haven't seen him.
They must hate you.
They must.
Just because you're very different than every other house in that neighborhood.
So I get a little...
Doorbell?
Yeah, well, yeah.
Well, I see you're looking for it. I think we could just say doorbell.
Okay, ding dong. I get a little doorbell, and it's, you know, I'm still in bed. So I just throw on yesterday's clothes and run downstairs, and I'm like, hello? Mm. He goes, hi, I'm your neighbor over here. He goes, my son's toy is in your yard. So I'm like, oh, okay, and I'm thinking it's a basketball or something. He goes, it's a little mechanical flying bird. All right.
You're going to be retrieving that.
I'll look for it. I know.
You're going to be retrieving that twice a week, my friend.
That's all
little
I was thinking.
Little kid trying to fly his...
When I looked at it... You ever see those things? They're the little birds that go... They're made out of very lightweight plastic wings, very thin, like film almost.
I've never seen these.
And you wind them up, and you throw it, and it goes... And it flaps and flies like a little bird, but you don't know where it's going.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, it goes into my yard like every other bird.
It's kind of like letting a balloon loose.
Yeah, you know.
The fuck is that thing
going?
Balloon
so
hands.
So it ended up...
Balloon hands.
Balloon hands. So I got it and kind of threw it over the fence at him, and he said, oh, by the way, my name, you know, he gave his name, and then I said, I can say Anthony. People know my name's Anthony. Why did I stop saying my name?
You should have said, I'm Anthony, and I got hot chicks over here all the time, so, you know, maybe make an excuse and come on over and hang with me.
One of his upstairs windows overlooked the yard. I can't
quite block it. I need the fucking elm tree.
Don't ever block
it. To block it out. But I think occasionally I see the blind open.
Don't ever
block
it.
Sure.
Because that he'll always be on your side.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
When the shit goes down in the neighborhood, you could count on the guy that you've been allowing to take a peek at young
Snatch. Be an ally?
In the pool.
Yeah. Well, I retrieved it and threw it back over the fence. I keep my gates locked.
Of course
you do. Because the last thing I need is some kid going back there looking for a toy and you know, having
happens.
A Tommy Lee.
Oof.
Or a fucking Bud Abbott or Luke Costello or something.
Yep. Well, drinking out of cups, we got it transcribed here. And that this line...
I better fist. I better fatalisk burned. Patters going patter little kid in the background fucking going crazy.
Oh, yeah, I don't know if the translation's right.
Well, it says, how about a fist?
I thought he said, how about a...
How about a fist? How about a fatalisk?
I better have fist.
Oh, really?
How about a fatalisk T-barned?
T-barned. Patters compel...
Patters compel... Tell a little kid in the background fucking going crazy. I don't know if that's right.
Let me hear it one more time while I read along.
I better fist. I better fatalisk burned. Patters going patter a little kid in the background fucking going crazy.
I think it's I better have fist, not how about a fist.
I better
I think
have
it's
fist?
I better have fist. I better have fatalisk burned.
How, what a great feeling. Like your brain is just misfiring and then all of a sudden it goes it's back crazy. On track. And then he's got a nice thought there.
I'm the king of the trees.
Fucking going crazy.
I'm the tree meister. I count on him.
Tree meister.
Tree meister. He's the best.
What else is going on in the world?
In the world.
God, we had such a busy show Friday. This story is kind of getting old, so let's get it out there. An amazing thing happened in New York City Thursday or Friday of last week.
Oh, I can think of 20 things that this could be.
And, you know... We talk about how they love to give tickets in this fine city of ours.
Yes.
Listen to this story if you haven't heard it yet.
Jennifer Morales, who doesn't want her face shown, wonders how her father's body could go unnoticed for so long.
I'm shocked. I'm surprised.
This is how the daughter wants to remember her handyman father, 58-year-old George Morales. Not as a decomposed body found in a van under the BQE on Wednesday. He'd been dead a month in a van with 4 parking tickets.
So they just kept putting parking tickets on a car or a van that had a dead body in it. Can you see the dead body, though?
As a decomposing guy. Now, if the guy was in the back trying to get some shit.
Well, they're making it sound like the guy was still at the wheel.
Before he dropped dead.
And they're assuming that he was just, you know, snoozing.
Yeah.
So if he's in the back, but it's under the BQE, that whole area is a dump.
Yeah, I know.
How would you know if you're smelling a dead body?
That's true.
Morales' daughter says her father left their apartment here in Washington Heights on May 5th in a van owned by a friend. Morales was headed for Long Island and just vanished. His daughter suspects Morales, who suffered from diabetes and heart problems, may have felt ill and pulled off the road for a nap. A window was cracked. The odor became overpowering. Oh. After the car was ticketed each Monday for a month, a marshal about to tow the van noticed a body in the back seat.
If you see that a car has already 3 or 4 tickets and you're just slabbing more, you know, at least call 911.
When he was found, his daughter says he was not covered with a blanket or coat, but in plain view of anyone who looked inside. She wonders, what if there were a person inside a car who was ill and needed help?
All right, you know, it's
well, you could wonder all
you
like,
but
nobody noticed.
She's trying to make a big, like, you know,
yeah,
I need a walk. We need to all walk on a Saturday with ribbons to make sure this doesn't happen again.
Yeah, they probably fucking thought he was asleep, and the ticket people probably didn't notice.
I'm not a fan of the parking ticket like anybody.
No.
Jeez, what the fuck?
No one's fault he was rotting, but him and his fucking rotten blood sugar issues. Don't blame anybody for that. You want to prevent that from happening? Tell Pop to get a motel room and sleep, not fucking do it under the BQE.
Yeah, I guess there was, a back seat in there. I was thinking like a work van, but... He was probably in one of the back seats, just kind of curled up.
No one
looks
so.
In there. Those fucking people come by, they look at the Reggie, and they fucking write the ticket or print it out or whatever. Scan your registration now.
That pisses me off.
Spits the ticket out.
So now they're barely at your car.
Yeah, that's it.
Because I like seeing the nervous guys.
Yeah.
Where they're writing the ticket just hoping that the person isn't going to be coming out of a nearby store.
Oh, they give them problems anyway. Fickers.
You want a weirdo story? We got a weirdo.
Weirdo.
We have two of these, actually. We have a young one and an old one.
Young weirdo, old weirdo.
Well,
oh, young weirdo, I think you know which one. Is this like the horrific story?
Which one?
17 years old? Is that the one you mean it?
Yeah.
What? Oof.
Well, there was a whole thing that happened.
Oh, Uncle Paul.
That fucking asshole.
Yeah. What they're only charging him with rape, probably, because
rape and murdered an 18-month-old?
An 8-month-old.
8-month-old.
I'm guessing like it wasn't a sexual rape. It was probably something. The kid, it was a horrible story.
No, it was sexual rape.
I don't think that he. I wonder if he fucked the kid or if he just put something his ass. You think so?
Oh, put something.
Hmm. Like, I think what happened was this 17-year-old boyfriend of the kid's mother. The kid was crying. The guy was just beating this kid. And he said that the kid, they found bruises in the kid's rectum or tears. So that he said, oh, he shit, and I was trying to wipe him and I hurt him. But that's a lie. He probably
wipe him with a lump hammer.
Well, yeah, or a stick. But he probably inserted something angrily to hurt the kid, as opposed to. But that's a rape with an object.
Sure.
What's wrong with people?
And he has a record. This guy, a guy like that, they should just lay him down and just put a bullet in his head.
Yeah, there is no reason that this guy should even be part of society anymore.
He has nothing to offer.
Nothing.
The People Against the Death Penalty, they come out when stories like this happen.
Oh, always.
Well, every life is
that
shut.
Just
it.
Amazes me.
We are not the executioners. God will shut it.
We haven't killed somebody in this country in a long time. We might kill that dude in California.
Texas still kills people.
What's the fire dude story?
I don't know.
Oh,
they gave him the death penalty, I believe.
Don't they? California?
What the hell was the story? I didn't think we were going down this road. Maybe if you could find it for us. I think he set some fires and some guys died.
Oh, yeah, they got a lot of that.
I think some of the fire guys died, and now they gave him the death penalty. It's a big story, if you can find that one for me, now that we brought it to the table.
Wow, that one can't hold up.
Huh?
That one can't hold up.
None of them hold up anymore.
I know.
None of them. It's a fake thing now. This death penalty.
Appeals after appeals.
Not to bore people with the same old shit, but, you know, New York has a death penalty. It
never used it.
It was enacted, 15, 17 years ago?
Yeah, whatever.
15 years ago, maybe?
When Pataki first
we haven't killed
in.
Anybody.
No.
Not a one.
Faggots.
It's a fake thing.
Those people in the strap in that chair. What gurney, whatever they do.
I say you kill people just to have more room on the highways.
That would be nice.
For real.
See if they could drive right.
Here is the weirdo. Well, if you do this first, that would really help.
Close the little door.
This is a day Moshe Kai will remember for the rest of his life.
Exciting. First time I'm graduating.
I'm super proud.
Uh-oh.
I'm so excited, and this day finally come. We just so joyful, yeah.
This day has finally come for an 11-year-old. Everyone finally. Very, very excited. What do you guys think?
I think, got laid.
Mm,
no.
That would be a good answer. Nobel for you, my
obviously.
Friend.
He got a hair on his wiener?
He got one hair on his wiener.
No, he graduated.
Not me. No way. Not once. Not never.
He graduated? Never. Yes.
He graduated.
Yes, good. 11 years old.
The sixth grade.
Kindergarten. He's a dunce.
He's a blithering idiot.
Complete dunderhead.
Dunderhead.
He would eat the chairs. They would leave him back.
Well, listen to what this braggart's up to.
Yes, the 11-year-old will be a graduate. A college graduate. Jesus.
I don't consider myself a genius or because...
You are.
Consider myself a hardworking person that uses willpower.
No, you're a genius.
Is he a little Asian child?
You're 11 years old. You're a genius.
Is he a little Asian child?
You got to think.
He just...
You don't mind that stereotype, right, Asians?
Was they're very, very, very smart, hardworking people.
They were bright people.
Yes.
Well, he's saying like every 11-year-old could, you know, graduate college.
Yeah, I just worked hard. No.
No, you got something a little special.
There's lots of dummies out there that doesn't matter how hard they work. They need the Sylvan Center. Bunch of fucking retards. Have to send your kid there. Oof.
What's that, Ann? I can't read from here. Death sentence in wildfire that killed 5.
Oh.
Yes, Steve.
A Southern California auto mechanic was sentenced to death Friday for setting a wildfire that killed a U.S. Forest Service firefighting crew in 2006. Raymond Lee Euler, 38, heard the penalty pronounced in a hearing in Riverside Superior Court. The Contra Costa Times reported Judge W. Charles Morgan said he had no reason to override the recommendation the jury rendered in March. He was found guilty on March 6th of 5 counts of first-degree murder and 37 other felonies for setting the Esperanza fire in the San Jacinto.
It's not going to hold up. It's right. It's not going to hold up.
They'll appeal
a good lawyer
that.
Will get him out. He'll get life in prison or something.
Because they can't prove he intended to kill people.
Thank you, Jimmy. Exactly.
They'll say he considered a property crime.
Yeah, he'll say, I wanted to burn up some property. My plan wasn't to kill people.
It's one of these
unfortunate for those five guys, obviously.
It's the eco-terrorists, man, where they start fires and burn people's houses down and shit. Spoiled little fuckers, for the most part, ought to be drowned.
Let's get the second part of the 11-year-old graduating college.
We first met Moshe when he was just starting college at 8 years old. He says he keeps pretty busy.
Stop it. How the fuck at 8 do you start college? It's impossible math-wise. Like, it doesn't work out. You fucking shoot out of the womb and you're in the 5th grade? What the fuck happened to this kid?
That's really funny.
There's no way. It doesn't. What, 8 years old. It's
what
like,
grade
yeah,
are you supposed
to
be in at 7? Second grade? Is that about right?
Yeah.
First, second grade? So someone saw him in the second grade and goes, you know,
he's good enough for college.
We got to go right to college with
right
this
to
kid.
College. Fuck it. He
How
did
do you
so
make
well
that leap?
Coloring.
Look, I don't mean to brag a little bit, but I knew a little something about math when I was growing up. And I got pushed forward a few grades, and I thought that was an amazing feat.
You don't want to do that.
I was one of those fuckers in grammar school, already in junior high math and all that.
Yeah, but you told us you were a math whiz, and then we were doing those calculations for gallons.
Oh, yeah, I lost it all.
I've seen chimps with their toes do better calculations.
Oh, you're 100% right. And I got nephews and nieces moving up to that algebra and stuff, and you know, I've bragged about the fact that I know math.
Yeah.
I can't even do a simple algebra problem anymore.
You do know that
I can do the simple ones, actually. But
did you see the phone?
What happened? Yeah.
Okay.
Some teenager solved a 300-year-old math problem.
Mm-hmm.
Really? It was a 300-year-old math problem that some teenager took a few months and solved.
How smart could they have been 300 years ago?
Mathematically?
Yeah.
Same thing as now.
Dude, the answer was 9.
Yeah, I know that. And you know that. But they didn't.
I just didn't feel like getting the credit. I figured, you know what? Give someone else the credit.
Let someone else go with it.
Yeah, I got enough cool stuff happening to me.
There's no reason for there to be an X or a P with numbers.
Thank you, Jimmy. You're 100%
this is unnecessary.
Right. You're so right.
He says he keeps pretty busy. His passion for piano, martial arts, and of course, there was school. Favorite subjects.
Math, physics, astronomy. Tougher is better.
So it's not surprising he found himself tutoring others.
I'd like to help them to bring to my level.
For now, things are leveling off for Moshe. He'll take a break for 6 months. Then it's off to a 4-year university. He likes MIT, Stanford, Harvard, Berkeley, a bunch of other top schools. And when he enrolls, he'll still be 11. So what do you want to be when you grow up?
The future is not ours to see, but I tend to be an astrophysicist, a movie actor, and compete in the 2016 Olympics.
He'll probably do it all. He's Michio Kaku Jr.
Kid sounds like a little troublemaker.
Yeah.
A bum.
He plays piano. Like, how do you have time to go through all the grades, play fucking piano, tutor other kids? Oh.
Imagine being the father of that kid, knowing that you are a dummy compared to your 11-year-old.
Yeah. Run circles around you.
Oh, you want to play catch outside, son?
He needs to smoke some
weed.
No,
I'm figuring out string theory.
It'll screw him up.
Theories this afternoon, Dad.
Once he sticks his dick in one girl, it's over. Die! 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 You shoot one load and you're a moron.
You know what? I think we got another little bit to this story here.
Yeah?
I bet a fatalesque burned Patterson patted a little kid in the background fucking going crazy.
Yeah, he's going crazy. All right. 11 years old, graduating college.
And what a gang.
And on the other side of this college thing, we got a 90-year-old. We're going to get to that in a second.
Yeah.
But we got Brett Michaels, tour manager on the line, Pete. Hey, Pete, what's up, buddy?
What's going on, guys? Hey, don't forget guitar player as well. Guitar player and tour manager.
Oh, fuck yeah. That's right. What's up, Pete?
How are you this wonderful morning?
Very good. We have to know what happened to Brett. We saw the clip from the Tony Awards.
Wait. Ants misrepresenting us. We did not watch the Tony Awards, okay?
I said we saw the clip.
If we knew Brett was on it, maybe we would have watched the beginning of the Tonys. But we saw the clip this morning.
Right, it was the
we don't watch
minutes.
That stuff.
You could have gotten away with it in the first couple minutes and still said you didn't watch the Tony Awards.
Yeah. Right.
All right, good.
So now,
on the same page.
What I saw was this. Let me know how accurate I was here. They're all playing. Brett decides he's going to get that last bit of hay from the crowd. And as he turns to walk back, everyone else is already up on the riser, kind of behind this big piece of set that was coming down. And Brett, I think from his cowboy hat, didn't see the big piece of equipment and bam, smacked right into it with his head and hit the ground. Tell me what happened.
From watching it on YouTube and stuff, I imagine that's exactly what it looks like. But, let's be honest with you. The entire thing was timed to a T. It was rehearsed and rehearsed again, and Brett's a pro with all that stuff. And that drop was falling a little bit ahead of time. It was falling faster than it should. And Brett had confidence as many times as they'd walked through it that he'd be able to not get hit. And
well, how about he ducks?
He tried ducking when he realized, like, oh, fuck.
He went face first into that thing.
I mean, the cowboy hat definitely probably obstructed the view a little bit.
Yeah.
Again, they'd done it so many times, and it'd gone off flawlessly during rehearsals that he walked with confidence because the entire thing was timed to the music. Everything was timed perfectly.
Yeah, he did walk with confidence right into that thing.
So the curtain dropped. The curtain cue was dropping just a little earlier than it was supposed to.
So how is he doing? Did he get any injuries from that?
Yeah, man. Yeah, his nose is broke from what I understand.
Holy shit!
He's got some stitches and stuff. It cut his lip up and his nose pretty good.
God damn! Yeah, they cut right away from when it happened. They cut to some woman who was just kind of looking like, ooh.
Now, when you saw that, did you howl with laughter like we did?
I actually didn't see it. I was in the hotel across the street doing some business and stuff, and I got the call to come running over there.
Oh, okay.
So I probably saw it the same time you did on YouTube.
Yeah.
Why don't we get Brett on the phone today?
I guess he's out of town. What?
All right. He's got a cell phone.
He's got a
what
cell
the
phone.
Fuck? That's come true. On.
Brett, after he after the award show last night, he took his private jet and had to go to an undisclosed place after he got stitched up to take care of some other business. So
an abortion.
No, Jesus. He had to get a
hey,
trip.
Pete's laughing. He went with it.
Oh, great.
All right, so who's pregnant?
Well, there's three or four of those Rock and Roll girls are pregnant right now, aren't they?
Wow. Damn.
From seasons 1, 2, and 3.
It's going to cost them a couple of bucks.
Yeah, well,
yes,
we're glad
well, luckily he's got the money to spend. So.
Yeah.
We're glad he's okay. Only a broken nose. That's all right. And a lot of exposure today.
Face plant.
I think I would take a broken nose for a lot of exposure. I think you guys are happy. It's all over the place.
That's kind of the way he was at the end of it. You know, you laugh a little bit. I mean, he's been through motorcycle accidents and fights on stage. You know, Bob Dole threw the bass at him pretty hard a couple of years ago when he finished the set. So it takes a lot more than a steel backdrop to keep Brett Michaels down.
Yeah, Brett Michaels walking into cubes.
Yeah, no way, no how. Hey, I got to tell you, do they still call him Behind the Music? Because Brett Michaels, Behind the Music or whatever the hell they call him these days, one of the best ever.
You know what? E! Entertainment did the Brett Michaels True Hollywood Story.
Okay, right.
A couple months ago. And then, actually, in 2 weeks, they're doing, VH1 is going to air the new Brett Michaels Behind the Music, which is really cool because, really, you know, of artists that have gone solo, be it like Sammy Hagar or Vince Neil, this is the first time VH1's ever singled out the artist as opposed to the band they were originally with. So it's a big deal, and they're going to air it in a couple weeks.
Yeah, he's had a lot of stuff happen in his life.
You wouldn't believe it. There's
more stuff?
This is just the beginning of the rise of Brett Michaels. Next year, you're going to see some amazing things. The autobiography comes out, and the book is just killer. It tells everybody everything you've ever wanted to hear, all the without being raunchy and stupid. And I mean, it tells all the juice you'd ever want to hear, but it tells it in a very intelligent and fun way. So
cool.
Yep.
Well, what else?
Yep.
What else you want us to ask you, Pete? Jesus.
Just wanted to know how his
really
how a Brett Schnazola was.
Turned it into a 20-minute Brett Michaels commercial. I just want to know if he's okay, Pete.
I didn't ask for that. I was having a good time listening about the smart kid and his father.
Yeah, I hear you.
Well, we'll see you guys next time you're through New York. All right, Pete.
You got it, man. Thank you very much.
Yeah, right, see, man. And please tell Pete we say hey. And
Pete. Or Brett.
I mean, Brett. Sorry. It's Monday. And, yeah, tell him we said hey and all that.
You got it, man.
All right, Pete. Thank you.
Later.
Thank you.
He smashed his nose.
Jeez, broken nose for Brett Michaels.
What's the matter? You don't like your oatmeal today?
I do.
I hate that oatmeal.
I do.
That oatmeal sucks.
I do.
Downstairs.
It's not award-winning.
No. So we're talking about college graduates. And we say this every time this comes out.
Yeah.
You get one of these a year, maybe two.
Ugh.
This is your feel-good story, I guess. A 90-year-old Illinois woman gets high school diploma. Oh, fuck. She didn't even do the college thing? You got
That's
11-year-old.
Only high school? You suck.
High school?
You suck.
Well, you got to let. I mean, you know what? This news shouldn't have came out the same day an 11-year-old genius is graduating college.
Yeah.
90-year-old suburban Chicago woman who dropped out of school to help her family during the Great Depression now has her high school diploma.
Don't use the fucking depression as an excuse. It ended at some point. You could have gone back to school.
When did the depression end, the Great Depression? 19?
You know, after the when the shenanigans started with, you know, World War II.
I'm trying to think if I know my history.
Shenanigans.
When did
the 30s.
I was going to go 30s.
Yeah.
Okay.
30s.
Eleanor Benz left Chicago Public Schools Lakeview High in 1936. So was that the end? So it was kind of at the end of the Depression,
yeah.
No? Her senior year to take a job. Over the following decade, she moved to the suburb of, ready for this? Gurnee.
No way! That's
another
where the president allegedly had oral sex with a gentleman that accused him of having oral sex with him.
Right here in Gurnee. Crack cocaine
wow.
for Obama, right? Powder cocaine
yeah,
for him.
Yeah, that's what he said.
Yeah. Gurnee, and had 15 children, 54 grandchildren, and 37 great-grandchildren.
Oh, Christ. Well, back then, I guess you had to populate the fucking planet.
She was a baby machine.
No shit, huh?
She attended night school for typing and bookkeeping.
Good womanly jobs.
Wait.
Could she take a punch back then? They all could.
Yeah, sure
into
could.
Their place. My roast, it's burned. Bam.
Why would you take typing? We're all great at typing now, just because of the computer age.
Well, yeah.
Right?
Was she on the ENIAC?
And bookkeeping?
Bookkeeping, very important.
But she recently told one of her daughters that never completing high school was one of the greatest disappointments. Her children contacted the school, and they just gave her a diploma, it looks
oh,
like.
Oh, she didn't even have to work for it.
It says the school approved of her diploma, so it looks like she didn't even have to go back to school for it.
Why don't they do that for me? I got to be 90.
Take pride in the fact you don't have one, dude.
Well, you swear all you have to do is complete gym, too, right?
All I fucked up at
is
was
that real?
Some gym credits. Yeah.
What a fucking asshole.
Yeah, I know.
He's an asshole.
I thought you were me.
Nah.
So go back. That's a funny sitcom. The older gentleman goes back and takes gym class. Here comes Anthony.
Oh, all I am just fucking diddling the girls.
Yes. Oh, he's the oldest kid in class. He gets them drugs and fucks their heinies. He's Anthony. He's older than the teachers, and he makes more money than the whole school. He's an alcoholic. He's Anthony. He needs 2 credits to graduate. He makes $8 million a year, but he wants the credits anyway. Why? I don't know. He's Anthony.
Think how cool I could be pulling up in a high school in the Shelby. See, yep. I'd have a nice car. I can invite the girls over to the hot tub to drink.
You'd have right. an excuse to have the high school girls at your house.
So they would fucking
We're
clamor.
Studying.
Yeah. He tries to be everyone's friend, but he gives all the girls the creeps. He's Anthony. They think he's somebody's father who just showed up for no reason. He's Anthony. He drives a Shelby. All the kids key it because they hate his guts. He's Anthony.
High school girls in your backyard.
They say, we don't care if you have a jacuzzi. You're a creep. We all have them, too. We're rich kids. You're Anthony. Stop acting like it's a spaceship, asshole. It's only a jacuzzi. It has bubbles. It gets hot. We get it. We get it.
It's a long opening.
It's a very long show. Sherwin Schwartz has created it.
Sherwin Schwartz.
There's a lot of things.
Oh, they're going to show Brett get smacked in the face?
The video's big, and we just got TV. The exclusive. Broken Nose for Brett Michaels. They better quote our fucking show.
His legs
came off the... Because the press release isn't out yet, my friends.
His legs came off the fucking ground when he hit that thing. He was walking. It took his legs right out from under him.
That's right.
He's Anthony.
That's right. Oh, he tries to brag about things that all the kids already have. What a dope. He's Anthony. He tells them he has baseball cards and bubblegum. Anthony brags about things that would have been cool in 1975, but now everyone has them, so they don't care. He's Anthony.
But he doesn't care as long as just one girl out of the 100 come over.
The one girl who shows up has a Pete Rose haircut. He fucks her anyway because he's Anthony.
And daddy issues.
Oh, my chest.
Hopefully heartburn. We got some good phone calls coming in here. I think the phone number's on your unit. I don't know the fucking phone number.
It's a big unit.
Graham, you got something on the 11-year-old genius.
Yeah, did y'all ever see that episode of Dirty Jobs where they're milking, like, thoroughbred horses for their jizz?
Yeah.
Yeah, and they're selling them for, like, $30,000 a vial. I was thinking this kid's dad could start selling his jizz.
The kid jack off into vials and then sell it as genius kid jizz.
Yeah, they could maybe even make a Dirty Jobs episode and bring in the topless gymnast. And bring the dad in right before he's getting ready to fuck her. Mike Rowe could pop out and deflect his dick.
All right, let's calm down a little bit.
We got the concept. The kid's only 11.
Yeah, let's calm down a little bit.
Got a couple of years.
Yes. It would be a good family business. Yeah. Why not? You could bring in some big bucks, I'm thinking.
Sell genius jizz.
Genius jizz.
Oh, he carries a trapper keeper full of Hitler photographs. He's Anthony. He tries to quote Downfall to all the teenage girls. He gives them the willies. He's Anthony.
Willies. Let's go to Jared in Boston. Jared.
He is the only high school student that has hair plugs.
Plugs. I do not have hair plugs.
They say, hey. They say, hey, there's a toilet seat cover on that guy's head. He's Anthony.
No, I don't have plugs.
Just accept it. You do.
No.
They just changed the name. That's all.
No, they're individual follicles placed independently.
Look, you don't even have it in you anymore to try to explain.
Plugs were those eraser-sized things that they put in your head that made you look like you had Barbie doll hair. These are very individual. Every hair is individually placed. Takes forever. Not forever, but, you know, good fucking 10 hours.
While all the kids are having a catch, Anthony's passed out with guns in his hand. He's Anthony.
The show should be 25 minutes of the opening song, and then maybe 5 minutes of actual...
5 minutes of me trying to do pull-ups for credits. Something,
right? Yeah. Running through the gym. I forgot.
Yeah. Well, you know, I got to run through gym class.
Christian, it looks like. Miller Place. Christian.
Ooh. Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning, sir. Christian.
Couple years ago, I've been a fan since day one, and a couple years ago, sitting in a college class for coaching at Stony Brook, and the professor's in front of me is talking. He goes, yeah, there's some guy, Anthony, on the radio who's blaming me for failing high school. And, of course, that catches my attention, and he knows, the professor knows that Anthony talks about him on the radio. He's like, yeah, if he had just finished his phys ed classes, maybe I would have passed him. He was a derelict when I knew him. He had some nice things to say, Nicholas.
Was he Cirillo?
That's him.
Yeah.
You know
Coach
what?
Cirillo.
You know what, though? You shouldn't fail.
I was a degenerate back then.
Yeah, but
I was.
if you passed everything but gym, you got to give the kid the diploma.
Yeah, hand me the diploma.
Yeah, we all know Anthony better than that.
That's right. Exactly. You know why? Because when he was in high school, he had hair like Lawrence Hilton Jacobs. He's Anthony.
All right, have a great day, guys.
Thank you, sir. Wow, he's
He's a professor at Stony Brook now. What is he professing? Toes on the line?
Oh, shit. No,
bring,
you didn't.
Bring your shorts home and wash them every so often?
Come here. Why don't you have your uniform? Toes on the line. Come here. Why don't you have your uniform?
It's not a uniform. They're called fucking shorts. And no, I don't have them. I got my sneakers on with my jeans. What are we going to be doing that? I really need fucking, like, workout attire.
Stupid.
We got to fucking play goddamn volleyball.
This should have worked something out with you. That's dumb. Let's go to Eric and Maine.
Toes on the line. That's what I remember from him.
Why toes on the line?
Because we all had to stand at attention because we're in the fucking military for some reason with gym teachers.
Before you do a little kickball.
They think they're drill instructors. You're not. You failed fucking athletes.
Oh, that's true.
No way, no how. Failed athletes.
His anger at the teachers comes out when he's in class. He gets thrown out again because he's 53. He's Anthony.
53? Come on.
I don't know his real age. I'm Jim.
Let's go to Eric in Maine. Eric.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Maybe Jimmy can make a song about this. The girls are going to think he's creepy, but just how, imagine how the boys are going to feel when they have to shower with him after gym class and they see that massive arc.
Oh, boy. Oh, geez.
That could be a problem. That's right. Don't shower with the other
I'll
boys.
Take cold showers.
Speaking of that, his hog hangs out his gym shorts. He's Anthony.
His big, delicious cock should be black. It's not. He's Anthony.
Uh-oh, we got something. Sean in North Carolina. Sean.
Kumia. I seen him passed out at the 7-Eleven, but someone said he made it okay.
I'm in. First Bueller. Very nice.
Where's Mr. Kumia? Is he still on campus?
I think I saw him by the food machine.
Maybe you get a little like Rudy moment. You go back to high school and you get on the football team or something.
Oh yeah, yeah. That's what I would do.
Carry off the field going Kumia.
Yeah, that's exactly what I would do.
They carry him off the field because he's been tackled by a 6'5" guard and is paralyzed below the neck.
Dead.
Yeah, they have to carry him off and get a fucking tube so he can breathe.
But then they
blow him to this funny man.
Then they go, you know, he's suffered enough, so they give you the diploma.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they put it in his teeth, and he's sitting in that chair with his fucking staring straight ahead with his stupid little fucking cardboard hat on. Oh, he shits into a bag. He breathes into a tube. He's Anthony.
Holy shit.
They put the gown and cap
destroyed.
On. They put the gown and cap on your lifeless body.
Oh, he used to drive a Shelby. Now he wears adult diapers. He's Anthony.
Wow, this has taken a turn, Jim.
I don't think I like going back to school now.
That's what happens.
I know.
Jared in Utah has one. Jared?
While the kids are all having a smoke, he's old enough for a stroke. He's Anthony.
Hey! No! How dare you?
Let's go to Chris in New York. Chris.
Yo.
Hey.
I had a teacher flunk me for my gym class so that I had to go back for the 13th grade. And for half a year, I just took nothing but gym.
That's what I was supposed to do.
What do you mean nothing but gym? You had to do a whole nother year?
I had to take two periods of gym a day.
I had until noon taking gym classes. Me and my stoner buddy, who also had to take the 13th grade. Kept skipping out on gym.
You know what a bunch of bullshit that is, though, man? I mean, come on. You go into school. Don't give me shit about fucking gym class. What is that going to do?
Gym should be
the worst part is.
Go ahead.
The worst part is the guy decided to open a driving range when he retired. So every day he's fucking just hitting golf balls after flunking a bunch of kids in gym.
What an idiot.
Go for him.
It should be a leisure activity. Like, you're doing your school thing, and now it's like, you know, if you want to run around the gymnasium for a while, go ahead.
Yeah.
If you don't, that's fine,
Your
too.
Whole fucking future shouldn't depend on whether you did enough pull-ups during the presidential physical fitness test.
I love gym, but...
Thank you.
But what is
hated it?
Hated it. But what, yeah.
Oh, who doesn't love gym?
But what does it matter in the end? You got enough exercise when you weren't in school.
I know. Didn't matter.
When did you stop getting a lot of exercise?
Running around like
17,
a nut.
18 maybe?
Second I started smoking pot.
Yeah, see? 17, 18. Let me go to John in New York. John. Hello, John.
Hi, John.
Hi, John.
Yeah, why do I picture Anthony pulling up in front of the school in a black Trans Am jamming REO Speedwagon?
Oh, imagine how goofy that would look. Yeah. Oh, that would be the ultimate creep.
Sitting in the car with the windows open until that one part with the lyrics you wanted everybody to hear was over.
Yeah.
You would time that shit,
and
Jimmy?
Looking.
No, I didn't drive in high school, but I know I'm a fucking total douche. I know I would have.
I drove my Dodge Aspen wagon.
I had a Baja
bug. That's right. A Baja bug? No, that's like a cool fucking high school vehicle.
Dune buggy thingy.
That's very cool.
Yeah, that's why I was degenerate.
He's a degenerate. Did I say that? Raging Bull?
Yeah, did I say that?
Oh my God, this is a good one. Les in Alabama. Alabama, moon! Les.
If Anthony went back to school and he had sex with one of the teachers, would the teacher get charged with having sex with an underage student or what?
Oh, he got it all backwards.
Yeah, well.
See, I would be in trouble for having sex with somebody who was underage, even if I had sex with the teacher. Now he laughs at his own joke. See,
and cleaned it up for you there, Les.
All right, thanks.
All right, buddy. Let's go to let's go to Matt on Long Island. Matt.
He took you to the prom. He's older than your mom. He's
Anthony. Hey, fuck you.
That's funny.
That fucking guy nailed it. Fucking nailed it. Chris in Houston.
Hey, guys. What's going on?
Hey, Chris.
Go back to 1959. Hop in the DeLorean, Anthony. Get your diploma there.
And I'll fit in. Yeah.
That's bullshit.
Do you go to Hill Valley High School?
You don't care, right?
About a diploma?
Yeah.
I don't even think about it.
Yeah.
I could give a flying fuckaroonie, as they say. Doesn't matter to me.
School's a waste of time.
Fuck it. Who cares? Forget about it.
A few classes were worth it.
Not me.
And the socializing was very worth it. Got you prepared for the real world.
Yeah,
the rest of it was bullshit.
I did a lot of socializing.
Bullshit.
That's all I did.
No books. Way, no how.
With the book hands.
Reading books. Fuck
no
you.
Way, no how. Never.
Oh, he quotes a lot from The Shining, and none of the kids have seen it, so they think he's retarded. He's Anthony.
Oh, I hated kids like this guy, Joe in Jersey. Joe.
Hey, what's going on? I went to school in New York City, and my senior year of high school, I had my gym class as my last class of the day. I had a 1-to-5 schedule. I only had 5 classes. I was on the baseball team. The baseball coach was a gym teacher. He tells me, hey, Joe, is your last class? I'm like, yeah. He goes, see you in June. I said, I'll see you in June. Never went to class all year long, passed with an A or whatever. My two buds tried to do the same thing. They had to go to summer school to graduate.
Oh,
what were you doing to the coach that he gave you a little favor there?
Yeah, they were the coach's pets, you know, because they were on the football team.
I was one of the better players.
Yeah.
You know what? I kind of hated guys like you, but it makes sense if you're, you know. Oh, I'd practice after school every day playing for the high school team, whether it's baseball, football, whatever. Yeah, why would you have to take gym, too? It's a waste of time.
Coach Cirillo.
Working out as it is. Yep. But my senior year classes were even worse. I mean, this was New York City schools in the 1980s. Like, yeah, I'm around the same age as Opie. My first class of the day was ceramics. My second class of the day was English. All right, I had to go there. Then I had homeroom, independent study photography, and sports history. That was it. Then I went to McDonald's,
sports
and I was up for the day.
History. What, did you fucking go to school? Is that Trivial Pursuit? Come on. Sports history.
School, man.
That's not a class.
Mm-mm. But that's what it was.
Oh, what a fucking clusterfuck. I got so screwed. Stupid Coach Cirillo. See what he said? That I was a degenerate. He did catch me smoking pot, though, outside. I was smoking a big... I took such a huge hit off of this doobie. Outside, and I'm holding it in, and it was by the back gym doors, and they fling open, and there's Cirillo, like right in front of me.
He
took his pointer finger and jabbed it into my stomach immediately, and I just went, and just blew pot smoke out. And he's like, get to the office.
That sounds like a John Hughes film.
It absolutely happened. He poked me, because he knew, like, kids smoke pot back there. So he was listening.
Why are you smoking a pot right at the door?
Because then you were the cool guy that smoked pot by the door, even though the gym teacher came out every so often.
Oh.
Yeah, high school fucking thought pattern.
Yeah.
So he would listen, and if you're out there and he smelt it and stuff, he would fling that door open and just poke you in the gut. And you go, "Pah!" And I just blew a big fucking thing of smoke out in his face.
What an
and
asshole.
He goes, "Go to the office. Go to the office.
Now."
Yeah.
What is this about? This is just mean, Aunt. Dave in Tennessee.
Hey, Anthony, you're that guy that shows up at the party, 50 years old with a Letterman jacket and male pattern baldness. Well, you got the male pattern baldness taken care of.
A Letterman jacket. And I'm not 50. Shut up. Jesus. And I don't have a Letterman jacket. I show up. Hey, girls, I lettered in track.
That was an accomplishment.
Fuck that.
I lettered it in track.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
All right. Do you still have your jacket?
Now you're making fun of me.
Do you have your jacket?
Oh, hell no. Let me say hi
big,
to...
Did you have a big H for Horrorfield on your...
I still have the big H. I never put it on anything.
Did you wear it?
No.
Did you ever wear it?
Yeah. I got the big H for being on a varsity team.
Should have been followed by IV.
Let's go to Chris in Jersey. Yeah. Chris.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey.
When running, he gets cramps. The people call him Gramps. He's Anthony. punch it out, guys.
Let's say hi to Alex in Jersey. Alex.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey.
Hi.
Yeah, my gym teacher wouldn't pass me, so instead of going to summer school, I just dropped out my senior year and got my GED. Took the year off, went to college. And then I ran into him a couple years later, and he shit his pants when I told him how much money I was making.
Yeah, gym teachers make no money.
Oh, believe me,
they were bitter, those guys.
I never bragged about anything, and I pretty much never had contact with these people. But they've heard. I know a few people that I talk to that have talked to certain teachers that I went to school with, and they've heard of my accomplishments throughout the years. So, yeah. Sorry I didn't fucking get your diploma from your fucking school.
I think most teachers don't get it. Like, they should be embracing people like yourself in high school. But instead,
maybe I would have made a donation to their radio program.
Huh?
Maybe I would have. Maybe that's what it'll take to get a diploma.
No way, no
I'll
how.
Say, look, I'll make a donation to your radio program. I know they had a radio program.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll say, I'll buy you some equipment with this little donation. You give me the old sheepskin, and we're fucking quid pro quo. I got my diploma.
Mm-hmm.
For what? What do I need a fucking diploma for?
I got a GED 3 years after I got sober, which was probably I was about 21. I just didn't need it. And that's not a diploma.
Yeah. A fucking diploma.
General equivalency.
A general equivalency diploma.
I've never seen the phones lit like this to talk about gym.
We're talking about high school dropouts. What do you think? Our listeners are all college.
Yeah,
talk about
exactly.
Menza. Watch the phone fucking go blank.
Barry.
Yo.
Hey, Barry.
Hey, man.
Now, check this one out. Now, I was a state champion and all that in track. I'm the opposite of the guy who got the free ride from the gym teacher. I got failed. I got an incomplete because I refused to take gym.
I refused.
So you got here he is, Barry. He's a great athlete, and the gym teacher fucks him over.
Yeah. Basically.
Don't you take gym to be a better, I don't know, athlete or something?
Yeah, you would think.
But if you're already a great athlete, then why would you fail gym because you're not really going because you're a great athlete, like playing on the team?
Right.
It doesn't make sense. Oh, Barry's gone? All right, whatever. Let me say hi to Kirk in Kentucky. Kirk.
Yeah. Guys, I'm 16. I'm still a junior.
Okay.
Is that bad?
You got any advice on how to make it through the next 2 years? I've been listening to your show since I was 12.
Well,
I got wait a minute. This bitch.
Wait a minute. There's freshman, sophomore, junior, senior.
Right. Yes.
So you only have one more.
Junior. I'll be a junior.
Oh, you'll be
a
junior.
Yeah, we're in summertime now, so yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah,
he's
yeah.
He's got junior and senior year to go.
Junior and senior. You're 16, 17, 18. Okay. What kind of advice do you need? Why? You having trouble? You seem to have made it so far pretty good.
I don't want to drop out and then you pick up some chicks.
Oh. Well, then just leave. Fuck it. No, I've always regretted not graduating because it did hold me back for things I wanted to do. Not the high school diploma, but the need to have one in order to go to, like, college. I would have done that now.
I need to go to college.
Knowing what I know now, I would have done that.
And
although you would have known that I would have gotten into radio, so I'd have said it a lot earlier.
I think you wanted to go to college.
You like getting
knowledge.
I wanted to go to college.
Did you really?
Actually, I wanted to, you know.
Get laid.
I wanted to go to, like, I wanted to be in the ROTCs.
Oh, really?
I would have liked to have, you know, joined, like, officer school, officer training school.
Yeah, why didn't you join the military?
I was afraid.
For real?
No, because I fucked up in school and everything. And I knew I could just go in as the enlisted guy like my brother did. I wanted officer training.
Oh, I see. So if you got the diploma
and
all that.
Yeah, I would have had to have, you know, gone to school and shit.
I want your D-O-R.
D-O-R.
Drunk on request.
I could do that for you, sir. I was watching Navy SEAL training on the military channel. Holy fuck. That hell week they put them through.
Oh, can only imagine.
Unfucking believable that they're eating and falling asleep. They don't let these fucking guys sleep. They got to carry these huge fucking 150-pound boats over their heads with the rest of their boat squad. And the whole time, the instructors are throwing sand at them and shoving, like, oars full of sand down their back so they're all chafed up and cut. And then they make them go into freezing cold water and just sit there.
Oh, it's horrendous.
And then there's the bell, and people just get up, ding, ding, ring that fucking bell. You want to ring that bell? You want to ring that bell? Get out. And it's just a guy
in your face. He doesn't even talk to you. He talks through a bullhorn right into your face. Come on, what's your problem? What are you doing? Get over there. Now, because you did that, the rest of your guys have to do push-ups.
And then you just stand there like Private Pile with your thumb in your mouth as the rest of your guys do push-ups. And
shit.
Just the SEAL training looked fucking horrifically tough.
Isn't an hour a night they get to sleep for a week?
Yeah, even that is inconsistent. And then they eat, and when they're sitting in the mess hall eating, they show these guys literally falling asleep in their food. And then they try to stand up because they've been active the whole time. You know how when your legs freeze up on you after you've been active for a little while? And they're like walking like they're crippled. And then back out, same fucking thing. Lift that goddamn boat over your head, run around with it, digging holes.
Where do you see this?
This is on the military channel.
You find it on the old YouTube or something?
And dude, food, like after they put the food in the garbage, that's what they make them eat, is the fucking garbage. Oh, I've seen that too, where they have, because it's all just guys eating food. It's like they cook them food, they eat it, and whatever they throw out, that's the next meal. Like they have to eat that. I've seen that too.
They're constantly throwing sand at them too. It's like, that's got to be so fucking annoying. And then they make them lock arms and lay in the surf
as the tide's
and
coming.
It's fucking cold. You just see these guys shaking. They're freezing cold. And then you have to run with all your equipment on into the water, roll around, and then run back within 60 seconds or your fucking the squad you're in has to do push-ups. So you have to fucking do it or else you fuck your guys over.
How many guys we lose every year?
I think there were...
No, I mean lose.
Oh, dying? I don't know. They started out something like one squad started out with 30, I think, 30 candidates, and only 9 made it.
Wow.
Another one started out with 50, and I think 19 made it or something. Really, some of the toughest training I've ever seen people have to go through. Ridiculous.
Animals, man. These guys are fucking animals to pull this off.
Yeah. They bust them apart physically, and then toward the end, they just start hitting them mentally, too. They get a lot of that mental shit on them. They fuck with their brains.
Well, you got the phones ringing to talk about this. So why don't we take a quick break, regroup, continue with this.
Can you see they're all laying arm in arm in the sand with the fucking tide coming up?
And then look, that guy's just yelling at them.
And their legs are up, like doing ab exercises.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what? The yelling is the easy part in that situation, you got to think.
You know what, though? What they're saying to you, like, fucks their heads up.
Yeah.
Like, these guys are good. They know what the fuck to yell at these people. It's not just like, hey, you look stupid. You know, they're yelling at them about how they don't have the commitment. Ring the bell. Ring it. You don't have what it takes. I know you're going to be out of this. No! And they're yelling like fucking, no, I'll never do. And then they set up the bell at this other location, and they had one of the guys that was in training. He goes, you're testing the bell now. We got to make sure the bell works. Kneel in front of it. And the guy kneels. He goes, now ring the bell. And the guy goes, no, sir. He goes, we're testing this bell. You ring that bell. And the guy's like, no, I will not ring that bell. I will not. He goes, all right, get out of here. Like they were seeing if he would have rang the fucking bell.
You think they would have kicked him out?
Probably would have. He rang the fucking bell.
Shit, that's sneaky.
It is. They do like mind fuck these guys.
Wow, smart really on cool, that guy's man. Part. Well, you got Special Forces, Air Force. Everybody's checking in now. So quick break, and we'll continue with this a little bit and get into some other things. Opie and Anthony, stay there. Man, I got to listen to that show.
Yeah, right? Sounds exciting.
Make us sound like rock stars. Let's go to Brew in D.C. Brew, what's up?
Hey, what's up, boys?
Hey, Brew.
So I made it through Special Forces training, like all 24 days of selection process, and still didn't get picked.
Why?
Because they test you on all sorts of different things, like teamworking abilities and some psychological testing and so on. So you go through all that brutality, and they're like, sorry, not this time, but hey, you're welcome to come back.
A little don't ask, don't tell going on in your life there, sir?
No, actually.
They gave you a hot dog and just sat on it?
No.
You failed the homosexuality test?
No, actually, my 14-mile ruck time was slow.
Oh, yeah?
Wait, your 14-mile what time?
Ruck time. You got a huge backpack, weighs about 75 pounds.
Yeah.
And you got to run it out for distance.
Mm-hmm.
And you got to go 14 miles?
Why 14? Yeah. Why not 10?
Jesus. Big.
Why not 20?
Why not 2?
That's why not you
why
just stay
not
home?
Yeah. 8.
Why not just hop in a Hummer?
Because, you know, they're still using the old war tactics where you might have to walk in to a jungle somewhere.
Just get a gun and lay down.
No, that's true.
You guys do 14-mile runs in the military?
That's crazy.
Well, no. See, there's about 3 weeks in this process. The first week is all your really horrible stuff with lifting huge telephone poles and then running around the sand doing your obstacle course and such. But then you have 2 runs, 2 rucks, and then I can't remember what the last piece was, but the one run is about 15 miles, the other one's 6. The 14-mile ruck and the 6, and they're all timed events.
Mm, wow.
They don't even tell you how long. We had to figure it out at the end.
Washed out.
Amazing.
And that's what makes me wonder about professional athletes, because I did this on a knee that probably should have put me down for 3 weeks. One guy broke his feet, you know, and then at the very end, they have a 28-mile ruck that you have to do.
What the fuck? So wait, that's really
rucks.
Is that walking or running?
Ruck. Well, yeah, but see, one savage we had did it in, he did the 28 miles in like 3.5 hours.
Jesus. Wow.
Could you hold your thought, bro, for 1 second, please?
Here comes little Nikki arriving to work.
Let's all look at little Nikki's coming by.
Hi, little Nikki.
Hi, little Nikki. How are you today?
What's in the bag today?
What do you got in the bag?
All right,
little Nikki.
Looks like Ross's purse.
Brew, back to you.
Yeah.
No, but that's just what we do in the Army. We're a bunch of savages.
Yeah, well, that's what they want.
Well, we had one guy get shot in the stomach while he was on a turret, drops back down in the vehicle, gets back up, and starts shooting again. But then the second shot got right in the crotch area, so he had to lay down for a bit.
Is he alive?
Ow.
Yeah.
This is a couple of tough shots.
Yeah. They were just animals.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Crotch Critter brings up a good point.
Okay.
Hey, Crotch Critter.
Hey, what you're forgetting is that before these guys even get to the point to where they're at the school, these dudes are freaking monsters.
Yep, good point.
They've gone through all kinds of training to begin with. We had a guy in boot that down in Sandog. He was SEAL qual in boot camp, and this guy was built like a brick shit house.
Dude, you are absolutely right. I was watching the show last night, and all I kept thinking was, they are fucking monsters, these guys. You can't just get a guy that goes, yeah, I want to be a SEAL and jump in there. You have to start out
as
being a big fucking football player kind of guy.
Plus, you need a certain amount of military service anyway to even qualify for this. You can't just come in off the street and say, I want to be a SEAL.
No, you go through you go through basic training, and then you can, I think after that you can sign up, can't you?
Well, what it is...
Like right out of basic?
Yeah, well, this guy, they had seal qual right there, and you do your regular physical fit test, and you have to do, like, X amount of push-ups, sit-ups, all that kind of crap, run with your boondockers on, I mean, the whole nine yards. You're fully dressed out and everything else. Then, if you want a seal qual, then you go, and instead of, like, the mile-and-a-half girly run, you do like a 5 mile run in boots and everything else.
Yeah.
And you basically you have to in boot camp you have to qualify as what they call Iron Man. And then from there you go and they have an opportunity for a certain amount of people to seal qual. We had one guy and I swear to God, you know, I know you guys are into the MMA stuff. This dude looked like he could whoop anybody's ass at all. I mean, he was, like I said, built like a brick shit house. And he qualled. It's just, I mean, it's unbelievable what these guys
Yeah, they got to be giant. I was watching, when I was watching this last night, they show these things that they have to do with the boats. They're these rubber boats, but they weigh like 100 and some odd pounds. And they have to put it on the ground and then real quick, bam, lift it up over their heads and hold it over their heads with their arms stretched straight up. And you see like their arms are shaking and then they go, okay, put it back down. Now lift it back up, and it's like, how the fuck do you do that?
Let me. This is one thing that in boot camp there in Sandog, in San Diego for the civilians. But what it is, I'm gonna tell you this: you can do it right there in the studio. Get you a pen or a pencil, stand up between your index fingers, put the pen or pencil between your fingers, and hold your arms straight out in front of you. I guarantee you, after about 3 minutes, you'll drop it.
That's really?
And that's just a pencil. Imagine a Zodiac with all your rucksacks in it and six or eight guys trying to hold that motherfucker up in the air.
Are there guys?
Just put it on your shoulder. Just hold it with your arms extended up in the air.
Jimmy's doing it right now, so let's see how long.
Over your head?
Hey, let me ask you.
No, straight out,
Jimmy. Now you got to start over.
Are there guys, like, nobody probably aces this, but are there guys that have a fairly. If easy time with the physical, just guys that are just in shape motherfuckers?
Oh, yeah. This guy that I'm talking about that was in our company, man, I mean, it didn't matter. I mean, he was doing like the, we had some little Guamanian guy about 4 foot tall that he led all the runs and everything else. He was one of the company commanders. And he sat there, and the guy that I'm talking about, every single time, a mile and a half run, I mean, he was the first one down the line. He was a guy on. He, you know, we had like a little company flag and everything else. He's the one that held that and would run the whole entire time like it wasn't nothing. You get done after a mile and a half, and my fat ass is just sweating my balls off. And he's just sitting there, you know. Oh, okay. Well, is that it? Can we do it again?
Yeah, there are those guys that just fucking physical phenoms.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. You fucking do anything to them. They said after a while of this training, of like Hell Week. The physical part doesn't matter to the guys anymore. The ones that have washed out, and the ones that are left, pretty much you can't conquer them physically anymore.
Really?
So they try to break them down mentally to see if that's the end of it. And that sand, by the way, isn't just annoying on you. It gets under your armpits and actually causes cuts. It rips these fucking guys' bodies apart, the backs of their neck on the collars. There was a guy that was doing push-ups. As an instructor was taking an oar and taking oar loads of sand and shoving it down his collar behind his neck. And I would hate it.
That's called making sugar cookies, by the way.
The guy's laying
when you're wet and rolling around the sand.
He's rolling around covered in fucking sand.
That looks fun.
Yeah, we clicked on that. That's fun, right?
A lot of fun.
Hey, imagine it. Crotch Critter, thank you, but I want to give time to some other people here. We got a retired Navy guy saying everyone's wrong so far. Let's see what's right, what's wrong. Tim in Phoenix.
Hey, how you doing, guys?
All right, Tim.
Love the show.
Thanks, Tim.
Hey, actually, I'm a Navy chief. I retired April 30th. I finished up on recruiting. I'm not saying everybody's wrong, but these guys are actually prepared from the time they enlist for SEAL training.
Oh, really?
You can actually enlist as a SEAL now.
Oh, so you go through basic as a prospect.
Exactly. It's its own rank now. You know, we have ratings in Navy. I was an air crewman in helicopters, so I did insertions and extractions.
Wow,
these guys, actually, it's their rate.
they do prep while they're on delayed entry prior to going to boot camp. At boot camp, they actually get taken out of their boot camp company and do special SEAL training, you know, swim time, run. Once they get to Coronado, they actually have their own class where it's all prep prior to getting into school.
Huh.
So they actually are brought along. I mean, they're training. You're looking at a good couple of years.
Oh, here's a guy ringing the bell.
Done.
So that and the fact that these guys, I mean, the biggest guys you would think would make it, some of the smallest guys I saw when I was stationed in Coronado were the ones that made it. Like you said, Anthony, it's mental.
Yeah, yeah. You know, huge amount of mental fucking shit they got to go through. It's amazing.
Oh, yeah.
But sir,
when I was in senior school with these guys, and they were just the smartest guys. They were phenomenal.
What would happen, though, if the guy was putting sand down your back, if you said, look, that really makes this difficult. And it's making this very uncomfortable to wear this shirt, if you wouldn't mind not doing that.
Yeah, the sugar cookie thing. I did that in Pensacola when I was going through search and rescue school as a rescue swimmer. And, yeah, you roll around and you have to run around. Yeah, you chafe a little bit on that.
A little bit.
I could imagine.
That just looks unfucking comfortable.
Because sugar cookies just sound so delicious and fun when you sign
yummy.
Up.
Yummy. We're going to be doing sugar cookies? Okay.
Nice.
Oh, boy. Let me move on to John in Cleveland.
Thanks, man.
Thank you, Tim. John, retired Navy SEAL on the line. John.
And they have explosive paint. Thermite.
What's up, John?
Oh, not too much. How you doing?
Good, man.
Hey, a lot of these guys are right and wrong, but it's a detail that we pay attention to a lot of detail. There is a prep school for SEAL training. You know, when I went through, there wasn't that, but there is now. And you do declare it as a present day, but it is one of the most brutal things you'll ever do in your life.
Yeah, it does look like just fucking something that I wouldn't last 3 seconds in that training.
Well, how long is SEAL training? Not, I mean, we have Hell Week, but how long is the actual training for a SEAL?
Well, you have your prep schools, then you usually have 16 weeks of that. Then you have a one-year probationary period set to a SEAL team. You're looking at well over 2 years when it's all said and done.
When do you do Hell Week? In the first 16 weeks?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah, you do it right at the tail end of it. When I did my final Hell Week, I actually had stress fractures in one of my legs. I duct taped it so I could finish the run, or I have to repeat what they call every evolution. That means you start from the beginning. You just don't repeat that one segment.
Oh, shit. You got to go right back.
Exactly. You repeat everything from day one.
Are there guys
excuse me. Go ahead.
I'm sorry. There's guys that go through it like 2-3 times?
Yeah, you can do a max of 3 times.
Oh, okay.
You can reapply, and if the instructors feel that you're still possibly qualified or have the mindset. In SEAL training, it's a mindset. It's something you never lose. I've been retired for a lot of years.
And I'm still a psychopath.
I'm still edgy. I'm still, you know, I go into places. I don't like a room. I have to leave because I don't know what I'm going to do.
Jesus. He still cuts the ear off every Vietnamese guy he meets. He's very unpleasant at dinner parties and art galleries. Your food is here. Slice.
Because then you do your specialty trainings. You know, if you're a corpsman, if you're more demolitions, if you're a sniper, they set these teams, 6 to 8-man teams, to absolutely just wreak havoc.
Yeah.
You know, and you can increase those teams. You can double them. You can triple them. You know, there's assault teams, you know. But you run 6 to 8 guys, and it just, you'd be, gentlemen, you'd be surprised how chaos you can rank.
Yeah, I don't doubt it, man. Yeah, pretty cool.
But I appreciate your time, and I want to thank you again. So.
Thank you, sir. Right.
Thank you, John.
See you, man.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank God he's one of ours. Jesus.
Yeah, I know.
Let's say hi to Russ in Ohio.
It's not like the old days where, like, you look at World War II, we watch some of those shows, and it's like, you know, yes, I enlisted, and before I knew it, I was flying a P-51 Mustang. They're just like, hey, you want to be a pilot? He asked me if I wanted to be a pilot of a B-17 bomber, and I said, sure. It's like they just grab people off the street.
Figured out now. Very involved. Russ.
Yes, morning, boys.
Hey.
Hey, I trained with the British SAS, and their final exam, the United States Delta Force uses the same pretty much exam. It's 42 miles cross-country with rucksack and weapons.
42 miles.
You've got to.
I don't like driving that far. It's a pain in the ass.
Yeah, it's brutal. There's a guy I read about that literally, when he was done, the soles of his feet were gone. He left the. He's a legend in Delta. He walked the soles of his feet off.
Wow. We're just watching these poor motherfuckers holding up a giant telephone pole.
You'll never need to do that. I would say that, Coach. We don't need to do this.
They're losing it.
If you get a chance, pick up a book called Bravo 2-0. It's about a British SAS team in Iraq.
Yeah, also getting people talking about another book. Thank you, Russ. We're going to go to Mike in Oakdale. Mike.
Hey, Mike. Ant, what's going on?
How you doing, man?
Hey, Mike.
Yeah, you guys got to get the book, Lone Survivor. It's a guy from Patchogue who won the Medal of Honor, and it talks about his SEAL team going into Afghanistan and taking out hundreds and hundreds of guys, and there was only four of them.
Yeah, I don't doubt it, you know? These fucking guys are trained like motherfuckers.
Yeah, it's amazing. You really got to pick this book up. I mean, this guy's a Long Island-based guy, Medal of Honor. He fucking wreaks serious havoc over there in Afghanistan.
And it's called Lone Survivor.
Yeah, Lone Survivor.
Sounds like a good read.
Cool, man.
Michael Murphy from Patchogue, Long Island.
And when you look at this instructor with the mustache yelling at these guys,
yeah.
These instructors seem like really tough guys to make laugh.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, they're not silly men.
No, not silly at all.
And I always wondered what Bill Buckner was doing after he missed that play.
He looks like. Yeah, he does look like Bill Buckner.
To make these guys laugh, you got to have a good kill story, or you almost got killed.
Bill Buckner, man.
Or almost killed.
What happened to you?
It's my fucking knife. I dropped it. They're all laughing. What happened? I stabbed him. But, you know, still, what the fuck? The knife falls. I'm fucking shitting blood. They're like, get out of here, you.
That's how you make those guys laugh. You have to relate to them on that level.
On that fucking savagery level.
Yeah.
Well, fuck, Ant turning us on to something. I got to check this out.
Yeah,
now.
Really, really cool.
And it's on what?
On the Military Channel.
Military Channel.
Which, by the way, is now on my TV. It's just about beating out the History Channel now.
Uh-oh.
If the History Channel doesn't step it up with some new Hitler shit. The Military Channel. They had Best Weapons last night, and they were showing, like, weapons, a shock and awe. It was, like, the best type of shock and awe. And they rate them on fear, like, how much fear they instill in people, how economical they are, how transportable they are. And they're just showing bombs and missiles and all kinds of fun shit. Bunker busters. Great shows on the Military Channel.
Right on.
One of my faves now.
All right. I think we're going to change gears. We had intern David stop by on Friday to say hi.
Is that
everybody.
Who that was?
That was David.
A lot of people were asking me over the weekend, you know, why didn't you tell us who it was? And then when I said David, they were like, stop. Didn't even sound like him.
No one got it. It was weird. Not one person got it right.
Who's that fucking Rutger Hauer? Oh, no, it's Ted Danson.
Oh, my God. What's with Ted Danson? Oh, Magoo, you've done it again.
That white wig.
Oh, wow. God, you realize how long ago Cheers was.
God, Ted Danson, he's sitting cross-legged. What a long-legged asshole.
Yeah,
he's got fucking lanky. Spider monkey legs.
Lanky guy. He's wearing big Coke bottle lenses in his glasses.
Yeah.
What happened?
They look like shot glasses from Cheers, the bar.
Oh, come on now.
You pick that up, you can see Kirstie Alley's twat.
Oh, you pick her bunt up.
Let's go to Jason in Columbus. Jason?
How's it going, guys?
Hey.
Hey, man.
Hey, Ant, have you seen this show on Spike called Deadliest Warrior?
We had the guy on.
Yeah. Oh,
and
okay.
We promised him that we'd watch the show, and I think I forgot.
It was pretty good. They had, like, a marathon. Like, one I saw was the IRA versus the Taliban, and they get guys who, like, are either ex-IRA or descendants, stuff like that. It was kind of interesting.
I heard the show was really good.
Yeah. They do a bunch of, like, different scientific tests. They did Mafia versus the Yakuza.
Sling blade?
No. Well, that's all I got.
You did the boy.
Sorry.
No, we like how you talk.
Oh.
I like how you talk.
You had a little.
I don't know. Thanks, guys.
All right, feller.
Thanks,
fucker. All right, Jason. That's funny. He goes,
We were actually giving him a compliment, I think.
Yeah, I know.
We kind of like that.
Yeah.
backstage with ONA. So you had intern David stop by Friday. Bobo was here. Bobo comes by every Friday hoping for a little
some airtime.
Some airtime.
Yeah.
Most of the time, he just sits down the hall.
Yeah.
And then we walk by him and say, hey, have a good weekend.
For hours, by the way, he sits down at the end of the hall and, he gets a, hey, Bobo, what's up? Mm-hmm. Well, I was at the, no, I didn't mean what's up. I just mean hi. Don't tell me anything.
So, I guess David and Bobo. Wait, David and Bob. No, it's got to be Bobo, right? David and Bobo argue about pants. It's got to be Bobo.
Hope so.
We'll find out.
And now, backstage with O&A, here is Primetime Sam Roberts.
I'm Primetime Sam Roberts. And the other day, former Opie and Anthony intern David and show weirdo Bobo were wandering around the SiriusXM compound for no apparent reason. Nobody was sure how or why they were allowed in the building, but we were able to eavesdrop on an in-depth conversation that they were having.
Now, you were just laughing hysterically a minute ago. What's so funny?
It said Sean John on Bobo's jeans, and I thought that was hilarious.
Why is that hilarious?
Because Bobo is who he is, and there are only a certain genre of people. I don't mean to be stereotypical or rude, but there's only a certain genre of people that wear Sean John clothes, and Bobo's wearing Sean John clothes. Bobo's a short little white nerdy white kid, and he's wearing Sean John jeans.
I don't know if you could say short, a medium.
What are you laughing at now?
Well, not only is Bobo wearing Sean John jeans, he's wearing Sean John jeans with the zipper, the fly unzipped.
Jeez, oh, Bobo. Is that true?
I guess maybe I must have left it unzipped from the last time I went to the bathroom.
When was that?
A while ago. We left them to their devices for a while, but after a half hour, we came back and found David and Bobo still arguing about pants.
Who gave you permission to wear a black man's clothes, Bobo?
I think FUBU would be considered more of a black thing than Sean John is.
Sean John is black, Bobo. You're wearing... Bobo, are you stealing Sean John's clothes, Bobo?
No, I'm not stealing Sean Puffy clothes, Joe. I don't go to his house and have to say, Puffy, I'm going to steal your clothes. And he comes out with a gun, and I'm running from Sean...
A gun! Bobo, I didn't mean to get violent on here with
and
a gun.
I'm stealing a car from the Hamptons. I'm not playing Grand Theft Auto with Sean Puffy Combs' car.
David, what on earth is he talking about?
I don't know. What the fuck are you talking about, Bobo?
What I was saying is that it wasn't designated for black people, right? I've seen white people wearing Sean John shirts. I've seen people wearing Sean John jeans.
Bobo, you're not a black man, Bobo.
Hearing David and Bobo discuss fashion trends and racial theory in such an academic and educated way was inspiring, to say the least. We still don't know how they got in the building, but we can only hope that they got hit by some sort of bus on the way out. I'm Primetime Sam Roberts, and this has been...
Backstage with O&A.
Opie and Anthony. Jimmy from Jamaica.
Jamaica.
The island or in Queens? I'm going to go...
I'm going to say Queens.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that sucks. Hey, boys, the show's going great. I'm currently listening to the show naked. I've asked around O&A forums, and a lot of people say they listen to the show naked.
Nude.
Pretty weird.
Yeah.
You think there are girls listening to us naked right now?
Yeah.
Really?
Definitely. Big fat girls are listening naked.
Yep. And the hot ones, their vaginas are fucking drying up like they just got sugar cookies in Navy SEAL training.
Yeah.
We're repulsive.
iPhone. Apple's going to announce the new iPhone today? Or
some kind of big announcement. I can't stand that they fucking drag this shit out. I'm listening, and it's like I'm listening to the news, and Apple today going to make a big announcement concerning their iPhone. And they already made the announcement of the 3.0 version on their website. You can go there and check it out and see the features and everything. But now it's like, oh, now they're going to make the announcement. It's like, what announcement? How about you just put the fucking thing out so I go down there and buy it?
I actually know what they're going to do to make this, because the phone service has been a little iffy. So they're going to hand out strings that people can do like the old days with the tin cans.
Oh, is there going to be an attachment you can plug into the bottom and it's just a piece of twine?
But how are we going to walk around Manhattan, Jimmy? We're going to be running into everyone's strings.
Well, again, literal Opie.
Well, you know, what? You're not wrong. And they're going to have the apology app. So every time you can't get service, you press it and the little voice goes, I'm sorry, we took the deal. We shouldn't have.
It's the apology.
I still have no desire to buy the iPhone, my friends.
You're
most people
smart.
In media.
You're left in the dust.
They have their iPhones. I like my BlackBerry.
Left in the dust.
You like your what?
My BlackBerry. I don't say it the weird way anymore.
Why?
Because it got old.
It's a BlackBerry.
It's, no. So there's something big coming out for that.
What's the 3.0 doing?
Oh, my God. It does everything.
Like what? Yeah, explain.
Can you download your fucking notes from your thing?
Is amazing. They will have cut and paste. Ooh. They will have, I believe, their video. Are we looking at video? On the new phone. Yes, I'm not talking about just 3.0, my friend.
What are you talking about,
fuck
video?
People downloading kind of shit to their old phones. I'm talking the new phone that's coming out.
I could see video on mine.
Sure. My BlackBerry does, too.
Big whoop. I could take out my flip phone and fucking make video.
No, I'm not even talking about making. You can't watch video clips on your iPhone?
Oh, no, I can watch them.
So what are you talking about video?
I can't make them.
Oh, you can't make... What?
I can't take video. I know. No, dude, if you crack it and you fucking fucking do this and make it void...
What is it called?
And null and void is...
Jailbreak or whatever the fuck the term is.
If you jailbreak it and... I don't want to do that.
I had no idea you can't do... Like, the BlackBerry, I can make just dumb primitive videos.
Yeah. I can't do that.
Why?
I have to take a fuckload of pictures all at once and put them together. And then you flip through them like a book with a bunch of iPhones.
You guys drank the Kool-Aid.
No! They got you hooked. Phone.
Yeah, but they're making you buy a new one every freaking 3 months.
I don't care.
Then they add the video. Then they'll add something else they should have had on the one you already have.
More hard drive space.
All right, why don't they do that right out of the gate?
Because they have to do things.
No,
because
they want you to buy about 5 or 6 phones within 2 years.
You're right.
Oh, look at all my apps.
And it worked.
I understand, you know, they want you to keep buying their product, but they're ridiculous.
You don't understand. What if you...
Why don't you have a video camera on there, really?
They will.
Every phone has a video camera.
It will on the next...
But the iPhone was supposed to be the big,
They wanted to get it out with all
phone.
The good,
better
goodness
than
it had in it right away. So they did that.
Nah, they held this shit back knowing that you would keep buying new phones.
Yeah, because why would you fucking not do that if you were a businessman? Come out with some new shit.
It gets to a point, though. I understand, but it gets to a point where the word greed comes into play.
I fucking
How many iPhones
have
you bought so far?
This is just my second one because the first one fell on the pool.
That's the only reason?
When I got pushed in the pool.
That's the only reason?
Only reason. Same thing.
Now,
really haven't come up with
all right, the new iPhone, can you just download the new software or you got to go and just buy a whole nother phone?
No, I get the new iPhone. I go home. I plug it into the little dock and all the shit from this one goes right into the new one.
Right, but why can't you just like keep the phone you got and just upgrade that?
Because the new phone has a bigger hard drive in it. Or bigger, you know, flash drive, whatever the fuck is in here.
Right.
And the video camera capability.
Right, okay.
And like a video camera on the front, so you could do like video conferencing as you look at the screen and do things like that.
So when's the 3.0 coming out and when's the new phone? Go.
3.0 comes out, they're speculating the end of the month, and the new phone comes out in 2385, I believe, way
That's
in the
fucking
future.
Fucking bullshit, dude.
Oh, yeah, I know.
That's
I
confrontational,
know
Jim.
Any info on that, Mr. fucking high-tech Travis?
End of the month.
Faggot?
Same thing,
end of the month.
That's the rumor.
They'll release the phone and the software for the thing. Yeah, and I really need it.
Did you just talk to Travis?
Yeah.
I don't acknowledge Travis.
What?
I don't either, but...
Because you got your Tiger Woods ahead of me, you motherfucker.
He put AIDS in my jacuzzi.
What are you talking about? I didn't get Tiger Woods yet.
How's your boo-boo
on your
foot?
It comes out today, right?
Yeah, it comes out today. Oh, well, I will have it before you. Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
I bought mine online, so I gotta wait for shipping. I want to play today, but I think I'll get it by Thursday, the new Tiger Woods.
I'll tell you how it is.
What do you know about the new Tiger Woods there, Travis?
Real-time weather.
Yeah, I heard that. I knew that one.
Yeah.
So if you're playing a course and it happens to be raining on that course, wherever the fuck the course really is, it rains in the game.
They pulled
that. That's pretty cool.
They pulled that with the Microsoft Flight Simulator.
They do that with the flight.
That I got, which is great. You put real-time weather on, and you go for your little flight between two cities, and it's the real weather.
I like that.
I was going the other day from Brazil. I was flying to France.
You're still doing Flight Simulator? Oh, duh. Stupid me.
Real-time weather.
What do we know on that plane crash? They're finding bodies in the ocean, which I find amazing that they're able to find the bodies.
I know. Well, they wash up every so often.
They're not washing
up.
No,
they're in the middle of the ocean, bro.
Yeah, they're still in the ocean. They'll probably wash up, though, eventually, right?
Like
some Brazilian will be on the beach and go like, ah!
Yeah, maybe a fingernail by the time it hits shore.
Exactly.
After all the fish go with nibbling. What happened with that flight? What are they saying now, Ann? You're a good, you're a big flight guy.
Oh, now it's a problem maybe with a frozen pitot tube. A frozen pitot tube.
What is a pitot tube?
They've been installing new pitot tubes, before this happened on these planes. So the pitot tube is a little tube that extends out.
Wait, a pitot tube could cause a plane crash?
Yeah, especially on autopilot. Because it's the thing that tells the plane and tells you how fast the plane is going, what the airspeed is.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little tube that literally is sticking out from the front of the plane that the air goes in. And it measures how quickly you're going through the air, your airspeed, not your ground speed, your airspeed. So if you're going too slow, it alerts the autopilot or the pilot that you're going too slow. And that you're not going fast enough to keep your plane in the air, and you might crash. So they're saying that might have froze up.
Jesus,
because they were in these thunder clouds. That these updrafts were ridiculous. The top of a thunderstorm, very cold usually, and they're going through it, and it could have froze up and given them an inaccurate reading. They had something like 20 messages being beamed back that all kinds of systems were fucking up. So that could be it, but they won't know unless they get the black box, or they could look at some of the evidence and know if the plane blew up, if they see like charred remains, shit like that, or know if the plane broke up when it hit the water, things like that. They could kind of figure out by getting debris, but until they get the box, they really can't figure out exactly what happened. So that's where they are with that one. But bodies coming up. A few lucky family members going to be able to actually bury some loved ones. And
yeah, that's real lucky.
Have some place to... I must fuck them up, though, when they just look out in the ocean and go, floating out there somewhere getting eaten.
Of course. Still can't send picture texts with the new iPhone? Let's say hi to Larry. No. Larry?
Really? I thought you could.
Hey, yeah, I just wanted to say I've got a BlackBerry, just like Opie, and the big problem with the iPhone is you can't send picture text messages.
Yeah, I think that's going to be resolved. That will be resolved.
But
you
they
could have
done that
text.
A year ago. That's the point I'm making today. There's
one of my biggest gripes, Opie.
There's a lot of greed there. They had that technology. They held that back. So you keep buying, more and more updates and versions of the phone.
I hear
you. That's greed, my friend.
Well, you know who takes it? It's John Q. Public.
Have a good day, gentlemen.
You can laugh, but we're not laughing, sir.
That's right, sir.
All right. Let's go to Hugh in Texas. Hugh.
Yeah.
Hey, what's happening?
Hey.
Happy birthday, Jimmy.
Thank you, Hugh. Thank you, Hugh.
Hugh,
uncomfortable to say that.
Hold on, Hugh. You've been trumped for nudity. Let's say hi to Katie in Poughkeepsie.
Oh.
Katie.
Good evening.
So we had that guy in Jamaica saying that he listens to the show naked, and now you're saying you listen to the show naked.
Well, I have the boombox in my living room, and I'm getting ready right now. I'm going bridal dress shopping, and I'm changing, and I hear you guys talk about women being naked, and it was totally weird just to be naked listening to you, wondering if women were listening to you naked at that moment. It was so weird.
Katie's naked, everyone.
So you're naked? What are you doing? Just kind of laying in bed?
No, I was in my closet trying on clothes to wear to go bridal shopping.
You girls are messed up. So you're trying on clothes, so you look good, so you could try on other clothes.
Well, yeah, it's a kind of a high-end place, so I want it to look nice.
No, you
have to have the certain accessories so you can see how it might look with your dress. You have to wear the certain undergarments so that way you could,
What do you look like, Katie?
Oh, boy.
5'3".
Are you petite or are you big fat 5'3"?
Either way.
Definitely not big fat 5'3".
Okay, cool.
Little.
I'm not super little. I'm right on spot.
How much do you weigh? It's cool either way.
About 128.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, Opie. It's not going to help her self-esteem. Maybe she had big double D's on that little frame.
Yeah, we have to be more girl-friendly.
Yeah, yeah.
I think you're very sexy, Katie.
Yeah, I am.
Jason, Pennsylvania. Jason.
Hey, what's going on, guys? Yeah, with the pitted tube reader thing, what they're saying now is that in those storms, if it was giving a false reading, if they're going too slow, the protocol is to speed up, where if it's given an inaccurate reading, the plane would have too much G-force and would just totally shred the plane. And if it was in the reverse order, the plane would have just basically dropped out of the sky. So they're thinking they sped up and the G-force is torn apart.
Wow. I heard it went too slow and kind of stalled. And when you stall in a storm, oof. A little hard to recover.
I heard they were going at a medium pace, Ant.
Medium?
Mm-hmm.
That's perfect.
Oh, it is?
Your porridge is perfect.
Oh shit.
But wait, if they go to high, if the high rate is, how fast do they have to go for the G-force to rip the plane apart?
8,000 miles an hour.
Oh, slower than that. But I mean, they go like 550, 600 miles an hour. How fast do you think these guys were going?
There's an overspeed. The thing is, you can't accelerate one of those planes and get enough G-forces to rip it apart.
Right.
It won't do it with the acceleration of that plane. You can get enough wind resistance over the wings to rip the fucking wings off if you go into a dive and go up to, you know, 700 miles an hour. If you get right below the sound barrier, you're going to rip the fucking wings off, or the tail will come off on that plane, apparently. Those planes, ooh, that fucking fiber tail. Ixnay on the Iberfay Alte.
Really?
Yeah, like a nice piece of aluminum like the Boeings use. I like that fucking carbon fiber tail.
Do you know how awful a sound that must be? Wings ripping off?
Oh, and then you just know there's no...
Of course
you know,
not. Plus
you look
raining.
Out the window and go, maybe he can land it with no wings. No, you can't.
Cabin pressure went out, too, which is probably merciful because they probably passed out.
Oh, yeah, they probably passed out,
30 seconds or something?
Would you put the mask on? Would you just go like, you know something? Fuck that. I'm passing out.
That's gonna be,
I ain't putting the mask on.
I don't want to put the mask on.
Oh,
just land.
Oh, it's just horrendous.
Yeah. I'm just hoping I'll pass out, and then when I wake up, the people will be going, could you wake up, Mr. Kamiya? Here you go. We've made it to the airport.
Just a dream.
Oh, it was a dream. What?
There's a pile of shit in your pants.
Whoa, ho, ho. The devil's out the door poking your ass with a pitchfork.
Ooh, Stalker Patty's naked. Because
you've been bad.
Stalker Patty's naked listening to the show right now.
Ah.
Nice, right?
Hot. Good. I hope at the coroner's office.
She has a fucking, she has a little toe tag on that fucking hammer toe.
Oh, Jesus.
The same type of rope that Carradine hung himself with.
Could we get Sam down the hall because something's going on in pop culture? I thought it was a who gives a shit story, but they're doing a lot on this on the news today. This Heidi from I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here.
Yeah.
What the fuck's going on?
Heidi?
Heidi's from what? The Hills or something?
Oh, yeah. What's she doing? Some kind of fucking scandal with her and her...
Spencer? Heidi and Spencer,
Spencer.
I guess? Sam, what do you know on this Heidi broad? I mean, this show, I'm a Celebrity, Get Me the Fuck Out of Here, is a pretty popular show, huh?
Yeah, it's a good show.
No, it's not.
Well, it hasn't been good since Spidey left.
Who's Spidey?
Spencer and Heidi.
Oh, God. Have we reached a point where we don't have to combine two names of people? Just enough already.
Spencer Pratt and Heidi Montag.
Spidey.
No, it's just
yes,
Heidi.
Spidey, like Spider-Man.
Yeah, kind of.
What?
Except it's S-P whatever E-I-D-I.
I don't care.
Spidey.
What happened with this thing? People are watching this show.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know why John Sally would agree to do this show.
He does stand-up, too.
He's a very talented guy. What is he doing on a show like that?
Spencer Pratt's very talented as well.
Fuck no.
But they, they're trapped in the jungle and everything, and I guess...
They're not trapped in the jungle.
They gotta stay in there.
They're at a Club Med somewhere. They're just keeping the other people away for a few weeks.
No, let's be real here.
Spidey thought
what,
they were
what jungle are they trapped in?
I don't know which one it is.
I bet you're right on the other side of the freaking camera is a Hilton.
It's the Costa Rican jungle.
Or a Ritz-Carlton.
Oh,
probably
it?
A Ritz-Carlton. Yeah. Mm.
They got big spiders and...
Yeah,
Spideys?
Stevie Baldwin got...
Stevie Baldwin?
He got bit by like a spider or something.
Yeah.
What happened to him? Did he die?
No, he ended up okay. But, I mean, still, it's not pleasant.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, these guys are big celebrities. They're not used to this kind of treatment.
Hence the title.
Exactly. That's the appeal.
So you brought in some audio of Heidi and Spencer.
Yeah.
Spidey.
And they're quitting, and now I'm hearing Heidi's, like, suing NBC because of her treatment.
What
the fuck's going on, Sam?
Well, they kept quitting and then not quitting. I don't know exactly what their status is on the show, because when we left last week, they were thinking about going back on.
Oh.
Even though they quit, like, three times already.
But is it a live show?
Yes.
Oh, it is?
Well, it's live, and they go to pre-taped stuff. Like, they pre-tape the challenges, and then... what's his name? Our buddy Damian Fahey is the host.
Yeah, Damian's a cool guy. Yeah. We like him, but the show sucks.
Well, it sucks without Spidey, I'll say
that. Is this Survivor?
It's kind of like Survivor.
Yeah, it's like an easy version of Survivor, right?
They're celebrities, though.
Not for these shows.
But they're not. I saw the lineup. Who's a celebrity? John Sally is.
Frangela.
Who?
The comedy duo.
That became, that does Best Week Ever?
Yes, except...
Two big black broads, right?
One of them got voted off, though.
Wait. Frangela?
Frangela.
Is that two people?
It's Francis and Angela.
Look. No more.
See, you and I, we need kind of a combined name, because that's the new thing.
Oh.
They go on stage as Frangela?
Anthope.
No, I don't like that.
Opanthony.
No, stop already.
But that's got...
Granthony.
Opany.
Opany?
Opany's
that's what people
good.
Say. Opening, right. They get it all wrong, and they say that.
Is this audio worth playing?
Someone's saying,
Samgut.
Someone's saying the iPhone stuff is a free download, but you're not going to get the video camera unless you get the new phone.
Right. The 3.0 is a free download.
Yeah.
You get the phone, you get the download. But if you get the new phone...
We are... How... It's all coming together. A year from now, camera, video camera,
yeah.
Phone.
Yep.
Right now, like, video camera on my BlackBerry, primitive.
Yeah.
So I still have to carry my flip around.
Flip is great.
Right. But it's all coming together, finally.
It is all coming together.
What do we got, another year? I mean, my... I got
your... See, that's why you
my camera's
about...
at 3.2 megapixels.
Yeah.
So that's pretty good. That's, but it needs to be a little higher, fair. Right?
But that's where you don't get it. you beat up the iPhone. It's more than the video, the camera, and the phone.
That's right. It's the lousy service.
It's... You know something? My AT&T service is no better or worse than every other service I've ever had, and I've had every single one. I've had Sprint, I've had Verizon, I've had them all.
Ants really has never had a problem with his cell phone service.
My fucking... Occasionally, I'll be talking, and it'll cut out.
No.
And I'll be like, fuck, I have no single. But it's happened with every phone I've ever owned.
No, but...
I can't say it's awful.
I know what direction you're going in, but I just got to say, I'm not saying... BlackBerry over the iPhone or anything like that. I'm just talking about technology in general. We're about a year away from having those three things
all
in
good,
one.
Right.
All really good where you don't have to shop around for a video camera anymore or a nice digital camera. It's all going to be right there for you.
Well, let me
one thing
you
throw in your pocket. Nice.
On what's happened with the iPhone, it's taking away from a lot of gaming companies.
Mm-hmm.
These apps, the games that are coming out for the iPhone.
Are they getting better?
Are very good. The graphics even look great. They're fun little entertaining games. I mean, it's not like looking on a big monitor and having the inputs that you do when you have a keyboard and a mouse. But
how does it compare to the PSP?
People, very, very comparable.
For
there's
real.
There's some great fucking games.
Have you played the PSP?
Sims 3, yeah. PlayStation Portable.
And you're saying it's comparable?
Yes.
Wow.
And I think
I
it's just going to get better. The size of the screen is a little... too small.
Sure.
But Sims 3 is an app for the iPhone, and it's getting raves.
Hmm.
I mean, you could do everything you could do on Sims 3 on this app version.
Anyone playing that Sims 3?
I got
a few people, yeah.
You got it, Sam?
Not for the phone, the computer version. Yeah.
I'm a Sim.
Yeah, I like the Sims.
I kind of like the first one that came out.
But it gives you a little more input on what you're doing, like during off hours in the old game when it used to be like off hours.
Yeah.
You could still like do that, socialize, online play, shit like that.
Yeah.
What makes it cool, though, Sims 3?
Well, I mean, the graphics are a little boosted. They're kind of the same as the Sims 2, but there's way... there's more little things you can do. You can control the details better.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you can make, characters that kind of
really
look
like
you.
So it's not that much
like
different than Sims 2 after all this time?
Well, it's different. I mean, I haven't played The Sims 2 in a long time. I gave up on The Sims 2, and then I picked up The Sims 3.
He hasn't immersed himself in it
sure.
yet.
Sure. All right, so Heidi and Spencer, I'm a celebrity. Get me the
Spidey.
Fuck out of here.
You say Spidey so people know.
Thanks.
Is this audio worth playing you brought in a few days ago?
Yeah.
This is the big blow up. They had to get off this island. And these reality shows, they used to be 6 months. Now they're, I think we've talked about this, a month. Not even.
This one's 3 weeks.
Three. That's a nice vacation.
Because
I didn't even. Yeah.
That's a great vacation.
They do it 4 nights a week for 3 weeks.
So 4 nights.
It's on Monday through Thursday.
So the other 3 nights are in a hotel. Getting their shit back together.
Well, we'll find
this
out.
Sucks.
I gotta watch tonight. See what the weekend recap happened.
If they're only going live on TV 4 nights a week, that means there's a hotel nearby and they're getting spa treatments and fucking shampooing their hair and shit.
Sanjaya had to fight to make sure
he got the...
What the
fuck is Sanjaya?
From American Idol? Remember that guy?
Yeah, I did.
He's one of these celebrities.
He's not a celebrity.
Yeah.
Boy, they really had a tough time finding people, didn't they?
They got Lou Diamond Phillips.
Lou Diamond Phillips has the most tragic story in Hollywood ever.
King of the sci-fi, made for sci-fi channel
Let
movie.
Let me tell you why. Lou Diamond Phillips is the most tragic figure in Hollywood. And you know some of this, but I don't know if you know it all. Mm-hmm. His wife leaves him for Melissa Etheridge.
Goes lesbo.
Jesus. Goes lesbo. Then she's bored with Melissa Etheridge and goes back to cock.
Yeah, but not
Who's
his though? Cock.
But not his cock.
Who?
Huh?
Who's cock?
You know?
No. I'm asking, do you know?
No.
She had to cleanse the palate a little
she
with
went
vagina.
Lesbo and then back to cock. And yeah. Poor Lou Diamond Phillips is in a jungle getting bit by spiders now.
Tori Wilson's on the show, too.
She's pretty hot. What? She doesn't have to do that, though. She was a big star.
A big star. She left wrestling.
She fell, huh? I love the wrestlers that think they can make it after...
All those chicks
their time is done.
That's what China did. She thought she could still be a big star.
Well, she got kicked out because Triple H was
banging
the boss's daughter. So they had to get rid of the ex.
I don't know anything about that.
Oh, yeah. I think Triple H would even admit it at this point. here's some audio from I'm a Celebrity. Get me the fuck out of here.
You just thought it would be easier?
I don't know. I mean, I cannot not have sex with you for that long.
If you weren't here, I would already
left. I feel like I could do this for so long if there was s'mores and maybe another change of clothes, but this is just almost borderline real torture. Like, I would do this to Al-Qaeda.
That's Heidi. That's when Spencer and Heidi, that's the first night.
She does know that Al-Qaeda, they live in caves and they haven't seen shit in years, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, well,
they haven't had a real meal in years. They're eating basically dirt and bugs.
They had just arrived at the camp, so they'd been in the jungle for like 3-4 hours already.
Oh my god! But the younger people are eating this shit up. Why?
I love Spidey.
Why?
They're very entertaining.
No, they're not.
Spencer talks to the show producer. Why?
Yeah,
they've been there 3 hours.
Yeah, but then he gets on the phone.
Weren't they listening when someone sat him down and said, "This is what the show's all about"?
No.
After 3 hours, like, what the fuck did I get myself into?
They thought there would be some s'mores.
Yo.
Spencer. Tell me what's bothering you right now. Just tell me what.
I love the dramatic music. Spencer.
Down. Ding, 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 ding.
I'm too rich and I'm too famous to be sitting with these people and cleaning up their in the jungle, my man. And this cast is devaluing our fame right now. I'm sitting next to VH1 comedians that I've never even seen before. I'm sitting next to wrestlers. I'm like, this is just not the show. I thought it was about to be all celebrities. Stars of shows get treated like stars, dude. I'm supposed to be cleaning up John Sally's in a bucket, dude. You've never cleaned up your own, let alone taking John Sally to the creek, have you? Don't throw me in the jungle and try to make me a little guinea pig torture act. Enjoy your dinner. Thanks so much for this opportunity. I really appreciate it.
This motherfucker. John Sally's way more famous than
Spencer Pratt.
Spencer? Way more famous.
What reality show was John Sally on?
A reality show called the NBA.
Spencer was on The Hills.
Yeah, good for him.
The Hills?
Yeah.
Gives a shit.
What a fucking asshole. Are we supposed to think this about him? Is that his gimmick?
Yeah, is he supposed to be? Is that his gimmick?
Yeah, he runs gimmicks, but I don't think, like, he doesn't think them through. Like, they don't have payoffs. So I think he truly is a dickhead.
A dickhead.
I think he's a dickhead.
And what, John Sally takes a monster shit in a bucket and he has to bring it down to the creek?
Well,
I'd watch that, actually.
They're kind of going over.
John Sally's a big dude. that all good. That roughage that he's eating in the jungle.
Oh, big nasty fucking shit.
We should start a reality show just called Take My Shit to the Creek. Just, that's all it is taking big dumps in buckets and making someone bring it down to the creek. What else we got here, Sam? Heidi now cries because Tori Wilson made fun of her after she thought Heidi quit.
Well, yeah, because then they left and they thought that the other castmates thought that Spidey had quit. But then Spidey came, and so they started using all their stuff, and like Tori Wilson started spraying Heidi's hairspray in her hair and making fun of her. But then Spidey came back and caught all the people making fun of him, and I guess she hurt Heidi's feelings.
Jim, are you into this?
No.
Look at the look you got. I'm trying to find an angle on this, to be honest with you. This is what they eat up, though. It's on every freaking TV channel this morning.
It's what the kids are talking about.
Jokes are fun and funny, but when they're at the expense of someone, they're just mean.
Shut up.
Like,
no.
I don't joke about people like that because it's just mean and it's malicious. And I just don't know why they're such mean people. And Tori's saying she's this Christian and, you know, born again and blah, blah, blah. But it's like, Christians don't do that. People, you're supposed to be nice, and I have really bad bug bites. This is not a very nice show. Well, not the show is great, but
look at her.
These people are not turning out to be very nice.
And this was after a few hours, right, Sam?
Right.
Bug bites after a few hours.
And they had already quit, and then they came back.
Right.
It's about winning.
That was hysterical crying.
Don't doubt it. It's the first time you're crying on TV is not fake.
So, oh, shit.
She just kind of exposed that the Hills was completely fake.
Like, she cries on the Hills, but it's all fake crying.
But the people on the Hills don't generally admit to the Hills being fake.
Everyone, it's like wrestling. No one thought the Hills was real.
What are you talking about?
No one fucking thought the Hills was real. You put that, and I never watched it. I saw, like, the trailers for it and was like, this is so scripted. It's fucking 90210.
So what does that have to do with wrestling?
It's fake.
Wrestling's fake.
What?
It's
fake.
It's
fake. They really do throw each other around in the ring and everything like that, but it's not. Vince never got hurt.
Yeah, well, he did.
His car never exploded.
I saw it explode. Yeah. That's not true.
Oh, my God. Speaking of wrestling, we had a sheriff on the line earlier. He hung up, though.
Yeah.
Jake the Snake arrested overnight.
I
spent some
that.
Time in his local jail.
What did he did?
I don't know if it's true, but if that guy could call back, we wanted to get to you, but you hung up.
I would guess drunkenness of some sort.
Yes.
So there's something
substance
called,
abuse.
It was either a typo or is there something called OMI?
OMI as far as what?
I mean, or OWI?
Yeah, there's like
operating
a vehicle while intoxicated.
Oh, operating while intoxicated?
But isn't that, OWI. What's the difference then?
They have the same thing. Some of them are DUI, some are DWI, some are OWI.
OWI.
Yeah, I guess each state or something
maybe that
has
guy
a different...
Will call back. All right, and then...
OUI, operating under the influence. Yeah,
yeah, that's right. Yeah. Okay. I never heard that
he was doing
before.
Surgery.
Spencer has now decided he's Boo. Here to win.
Yes, he changed his mind after quitting twice, and then now he's going to win.
You got to realize, I'm a black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I kickbox. I box every day. I don't fear no man.
Oh, Spencer. Please don't leave, Spencer.
Oh, I'm not. I've worked some things out. Well, I mean, I came in here with an original plan that just got so shut down. I wanted to leave yesterday and be right. The first one. It's like, Heidi and Spencer quit first day. God, I hate Heidi and Spencer. That's exactly what I thought they would do. They're exactly who I think they are. And then they're going to help me.
Damn sure got the audience thinking that.
Yeah, so I decided if I leave, I let all of these people that I don't even really know have an opportunity to win. I am here to win now.
Win what?
The contest.
What's the contest?
You get to win money for charity. You gotta outwit, outlast, outsurvive. But the audience
Club
votes
Med?
You off. No. They're in the jungle in Costa Rica.
I am lost. I have no fucking clue what this show is about, what's going on.
I think I wanted to play this just to get everyone...
Except the two-name thing.
In a frenzy, just annoyed.
Well, because you guys had brought up this show before without... And
we
I wanted everybody...
Really. We said, what a dumb show we'll never talk about on our program.
Spiney and Frangelica?
Spidey and Frangela.
Whatever.
Frangela. There's Frangela, the big two black monsters.
Except the one with the yellow thing on her head is gone now.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy, what will happen?
MTV does a marathon on Sundays in case you miss it during the week. You catch it on the weekend, all the episodes, so I'm all caught up.
Jimmy, why aren't you watching this?
It's not even possible to care less.
Look how bad you are.
Really? If something happened where they all died,
except for John
Sally, probably wouldn't even know about it.
I'm a big fan of John Sally. Can we leave him out of the death scenario, please?
No.
And Spencer.
He's got to go. No, Spencer's, all go.
I think we're all in agreement Spencer
if
has to
If they all
die.
Went.
What? Yeah.
I think we'd have to say your hit.
So we'd have to say Tori too.
I had a Spencer Pratt.
Hell yeah! Come on, John Sally and Tori. Rest of them.
Look at him
bye-bye.
Yelling. What is he doing?
He's letting people know he boxes every day. He's
and
a black belt.
Janice Dickinson is a old dried up whore.
She's a monster.
I fucking can't stand
another
her.
Monster. She looks like a wax figure now.
She started stealing everybody's things.
And why was she crying? I did see a clip where she was crying.
The girl's crying on these fucking
John
fake
Sally
game
said
shows.
Something.
I don't know. It's a very difficult show for people. They get very emotional.
Who's phony shit?
The celebrities.
The people watching going, what happened in my life that I'm interested in this shit?
No, people are entertained.
Phony crap.
I like a good reality show, Sam, but
me
they're getting out of control. There's no reason to watch this.
Well, because you don't know what Spidey will do next.
Oh, the
that's a good point.
Good. Yeah. And then finally, night two.
Yeah, this
that was all the first day.
That was the first day. And then on
this is the last clips, in case you're wondering out there.
On the second one, now they've done one challenge, and Spencer had to do a challenge, and he had to touch, like, mice. And so that was it for him.
That's the fucking challenge? He had to touch a mouse?
But it's dark, so you don't know what lurks around the corner.
Well, they're not going to put you in harm's way.
You don't know. It's the jungle.
We can't even have a naked girl in studio pretty much at this point. You think the lawyers are going to go, all right, really fuck him up.
But this
put some poisonous snake in there.
You're not factoring into account the unpredictability of the atmosphere there.
Dude,
in.
It's just, it's fraternity bullshit. We were blindfolded. We were told that an ego took a shit in our fucking toilet and we had to get rid of it because we were the pledges.
You weren't in a jungle.
So we had to go in there and we had to squish that turd until it went down the toilet. Getting rid of the sorority doo-doo. But it was a banana, see? The old switcheroo.
Thank God. I hate this show.
No,
and
you gotta
I've
watch
never seen it.
Can
no.
you watch one show?
I would never even watch it if I had to.
Let's do a show thing where we all watch tonight and come back tomorrow and discuss.
It's on tonight, huh?
Yeah.
How about we just don't?
No?
Please tell me the Penguins are on tonight.
I don't know. I'm really more concentrated on this thing.
Penn's playing tonight. Anyone? I don't think they are, though. Here's the last clip.
As much as Spidey is going to miss all of you, and we've grown to love you all, and I know we've said we're going to leave like 10 times, that challenge just proved to us we do not have what it takes.
So I think we're going to get out of here, for real.
I'm a super celebrity. My wife is a super celebrity. Super celebrities don't belong in the jungle. They belong in Hollywood with the paparazzi.
We will miss you guys, but call us all when you get back to L.A.
Oh, what a great voice on that girl, too.
Is she hiding? Is she at least hot?
Yeah, she is.
That could be the worst show I've ever heard.
Jimmy,
ever.
This is
yeah, horrid.
Ever. I'd rather watch Archie Bunker's Place.
Ooh, that was a bad one.
With Stephanie?
Oh, yeah. She grew up to take her clothes off, didn't she?
Ooh, all right.
Or barely, something like that.
I'd rather watch Aftermath.
Oof. Okay, that's really bad. But I'd rather watch that than this.
Really?
I'd rather watch that in fucking Blu-ray than this.
Blu-ray. I like the Blu-ray. Sean in Albany.
Hey, guys. Hey, Spencer yelling out how he's a black belt. First off, he's been given that under a blackballed instructor, which means nobody will touch him.
What are you talking about?
He was a purple belt as of a month ago, and then all of a sudden jumped the brown into black, which generally takes about 4 to 5 years for people that are doing it 5 times a week. And he gets regularly dusted by blue belts, which is the level below a purple belt.
Hmm. You know why he made the jump so quickly? Because he's Spencer Pratt, and that's how he gets down like that.
Have you seen his fake boss fight footage, Sam?
Hmm?
Have you seen the footage out where he's supposedly in a bar fight?
Sanctioned martial arts event. That's a bar fight.
They have to put Lou Diamond Phillips actor underneath. Did you see that?
Hey, supposedly Letterman called out Spencer.
I don't know, but I'll find the clip.
Yeah, please do, because... And what, this is the mouse they had to touch? Who cares?
Well, you got to put your hand in it, and you don't know what's in there. It's the jungle, after all.
What could it be?
It's not the jungle. That's a set, that's a fake set wall.
And it's a petting zoo.
And it's, yeah, they're little plastic tubes, like habit trails, with little fucking mice that you would get your kids as pets.
What if they bite?
Who cares?
You're bitten.
They would just nibble.
Look how much pain Lou Diamond Phillips is in this clip here.
Yeah, he's watching one of his movies.
And now they're playing Stand and Deliver. Ow, ow.
This is dumb. There's no drama to it. They're making... It's fake drama. They're showing Lou Diamond's face. He's cringing. And now they're showing close-up on the mice. And then they show him again. Then they show his arm in the hole. Then they show the...
Why is he cringing? They're just nibbling a little, probably, right? And their little mouse feet are moving around his hand.
And now what? Yeah. Tori's crying?
Those are jungle mice.
Why
What's
is
a jungle
he?
Mice?
They're not jungle mice. These are white fucking lab rat things.
They're the safest mice you can
docile.
Get,
docile. They're not even touching him. They're not biting him.
Then why is he making that face then?
To make a face and make some drama. Show the blood.
Show the blood from the tiny little mice.
I hate the interviews after that they have to do.
Yeah.
To describe their
harrowing
event.
Well, I was really, you know, at the time, I never thought I could do it. And as I was doing, shut up, who cares?
Out of that hole without the star.
Thank God the EMTs were on the scene.
Yeah, thank God, Sam.
They're just little nibbly mice.
They're nothing.
I put my cock in that hole with cheese on it.
You know what, for real, I think I would too, Jimmy.
You guys should do a show.
Knowing what kind of mice they are, what the fuck are
they
going to
do?
Let's say hi to Kevin in South Carolina. Kevin.
Hey, man.
Hey.
I'm kind of wondering why we're talking about these stupid idiots while we could be criticizing Britney's naked pics.
Yeah, Britney, I guess, got topless. It's in the paper today. She was going to use it for something and decided at the last minute not to.
It was a video shoot. It was like... Yeah, it was for
one of her songs.
Yeah. Where is the video? That's all I want to know.
Well, the music video is out, and obviously there's
not the music video, video of her tits.
No, the still shots were in the paper this morning, right there.
All right, let's see them.
Uncensor that crap.
Yeah, you got to click on the bottom.
WhatWouldTylerDurdenDo.com, WWTDD.com.
What's with the star?
That's how she did it. On
there. What?
It was like pasties, like she's a stripper or something.
Give me a better one.
Jet Black do.
So fake tattoos for the video.
Give me a better one.
That's all you really get.
Give me a better one.
She's topless, but she's got kind of stars over the nipple.
She looks like go back one with that her body. She has a body like fucking Ozzy in like 1981 right there with the way the fucking arm is positioned with the tattoo on the forearm.
Yeah, look at that.
Yeah,
I bet you she saw what she looked like and said, you know what?
I said, fuck it.
This ain't happening.
Fat forearms.
Oh no. Naked right. Britney's better than fucking not naked Britney, I guess.
It's an excellent point.
Yeah,
but she should have got naked before the kids.
They all fucking get naked too late.
Too late, right, Aunt?
Too late.
She is starting to get back into shape.
Is she?
Yeah.
No, she's not.
No.
Jared in Kansas. Jared.
Okay.
Hey, what's up, guys?
There you go.
Hey.
I just wanted to call.
All right, hold on. We'll go back to you in a second. What do you think of that shot, Aunt?
All right.
She's got muscle. Boobs.
Yeah,
you ever
see
girls with like muscle boobs?
There's a little too much on top, too much meat on top. The nips aren't placed in that nice, perky position. They're a little too low.
Yeah, but they're not sagging because you must have got like implants.
She did get implants.
Are popping up the top part of the boob.
Yeah, yeah.
Making them muscly.
I jam it in her face. Are you kidding? Yeah, she's still fuckable. It's Britney Spears, for
God's
sake.
We know that.
I'm going out on a limb saying I'd do her. No. Come on. Crazy. What am I talking about?
Jared.
Yes, sir.
Forget it.
Hey.
Hey, I was just going to say I had a little input. I was flipping through the channels the other night and saw the show on, and I watched Spidey get baptized by Stephen Baldwin.
Yeah.
What's that about, Sam?
Well, before Spencer left the show, he felt, like, dirty, and so he had Stephen Baldwin baptize him in the jungle lake.
In a jungle lake.
Yeah.
That was the pool.
No,
pool.
In between water volleyball, they said, you know what, make it a little muddy so it looks like a swamp or
Heidi specifically, she specifically pointed out the lack of s'mores, so this is not a vacation spot.
I am so annoyed you're still talking about this.
It's horrendous.
I want to beat you over the head.
It's a hot show right now.
No, it's not.
You know what's funny about the whole thing? We were talking about Navy SEAL training, and now we're talking about this, and she can't handle a night in the jungle.
Yeah.
We run the gamut here on the Opie and Anthony show.
It's true.
Yes, we do.
From good to suck.
And I bet a lot of money after the day of, you know, shooting is over. They're like, that was good. That was a good shoot. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Yeah. Go back to, we got a shuttle bus back to the Ritz-Carlton.
All right. Thanks.
Yep.
Yeah. And how about if she and I are arguing when you guys come in? Yeah, I like that. I like that. Hey, guys, you're going to put your hands through, but just really play it up like they're getting bitten.
Look, these mice, they're not going to touch you.
Yeah.
But you got to put your arm in there all the way. We put the stars pretty far back for you to have to grab. So really strain and make it look like they're biting you.
These mice have dentures. That's why Lou Diamond was cringing. He has effordent on his fingers. little mousy mouthfuls of effordent.
Awful.
Let's go to Adam. Adam. I guess this is our pop culture break, Adam.
Yeah. Hey, what's up, boys? You guys got to check out. There's Sam's favorite person, Lady Gaga. There's a video that leaked out. It's called, for her new song, Paparazzi. Check out that standard bullshit. If you had that, you'd be fired. She's pretending to be paralyzed in a wheelchair and does a dance with a walker.
She's playing a role here.
Yeah, she's acting.
It's on YouTube.
What do we know about that, Sam?
It's the new music video for a new single, Paparazzi, which, for the record, is my favorite song off the album, and it's going to be a huge hit.
For whose record?
Lady Gaga.
Keeping a record of that.
Nobody. No one asked you, Sam.
I mean, the album.
The Lady Gaga stuff is a bit catchy, but, you know, downloading it and listening to it on your own, what are you doing?
Purchasing the CD.
Purchasing it. That's stupid.
It's an 8-minute-long music video. It's an epic.
Oh, good. No, it's presumptuous.
It's her November Rain.
Well, no, because the song is not 8 minutes. It tells a story.
What kind of story could it possibly tell?
It's like a Hollywood story.
Oh, good.
I hate videos like this. Or the fucking story.
I just like seeing Jimmy annoyed.
Well, the stories are awful.
Starring Lady Gaga.
See?
Will there be some talking in the beginning?
Yes, but it's in French.
Oh, good.
Oh, great.
Oh,
what the fuck are we doing, Sam?
There's subtitles.
Why is it in French?
Stylistically.
Just zip through this, would you?
Did
you see the Lady Gaga
stupid.
Dollars?
Yeah, that's her face on a $100 bill.
Let me see.
She and this guy are making out.
Yeah. I really dig that heavy black makeup on girls like that.
Yeah, of course you do. Hides the fucking punches.
I mean around the eyes. I mean blackface.
Oh.
That's just regular.
Every time you want to come, they yell mammy and it spills out of you.
That's just regular makeup, Anthony. Just crying.
I like slut eyes like that.
Nothing.
Yeah. Right. That's great.
See, she and this guy keep making out.
There's a ram looking at them.
Is she at all hot? I can't tell.
This has the sex appeal. Of a pickle commercial.
Yeah, you know what it looks like? It looks like one of these stupid perfume ads.
Yeah.
So, like, you don't know what it is until they go, you know.
This is a good video.
Lady Gaga.
Is he going to take her now? Is he going to put his penis in her vagina?
Throw her off the balcony. Just throw her the fuck off the balcony.
Do you trust me? Of course.
Of course.
Who wants to
read?
It's a
weird-looking thing.
I don't feel like reading. Paparazzi taking pictures while they're having sex outside.
Wait, but the guy's in on it.
Oh, he's in on it?
She's saying stop.
But he's not stopping.
He's saying smile for the picture.
In the camera.
Look in the camera. What are you doing? Stop. Stop.
Oh, cool. This is good. Fucking rape. See?
She's struggling and she's going to fall off that balcony, I hope.
Oh. Hits him with the bottle.
Yeah, she goes.
She is pushed over the railing.
Uh-oh. Oh, hence why she's in the wheelchair.
She's falling.
She was crippled. Now she's falling.
That's the spiral.
She's in high anxiety, the movie.
Yeah. Steve, I'm not going to get you on the phone. It says Lady Gaga's in Playboy. She should be named Lady Saggy Tits.
Really? She's got Rolling Stone on the cover, nude, but covered with bubbles.
Bubbles.
Lady Gaga.
What a fucking idiot.
Now the paparazzi are taking pictures of her while she's laying.
No one's helping.
She's got the
down
fucking
below.
Newspapers showing up.
And now the song starts. This is the song.
Oh, now they're picking her up and putting her in a wheelchair because she's paralyzed.
We're on the road. We're coming out. Got my flash on, it's true. With that picture of you, it's so magical.
How come she she doesn't show her fucking face. Ever. She's covering it up and doing distance shots. Like, what's going on?
She wears heavy makeup and does dances.
I don't think this is art. I don't mind the heavy makeup, but now she's wearing sunglasses.
It's part of the
cutting every half a second.
She's probably cross-eyed.
It's part of the performance. Maybe she's Lady Google Eyes.
Yeah, because Ant's right. She's never shown her eyes.
No.
Maybe she had a glass eye like Sandy Duncan.
Oh, hot. Now she's going to try to walk with braces.
That's hot.
Now she's trying to walk.
I love a girl in magic shoes who falls on the rug. You just put your dick in her butt. She can't feel it.
This sucks a dick.
No, no,
Sam.
No.
You're
not even listening to the song. You're not giving it a chance.
What an outcue.
Being very judgmental.
She's cute little underbite. She's cute teeth.
I can't figure it out if she's cute or not.
Yeah, she's a great dumper.
She has a very sexual attitude.
No, yeah. She doesn't.
She does.
That stinks, Sam.
Yeah. It's called the attitude.
Yeah, exactly.
Sexual attitude.
She loves dick, though.
Yes, she does.
Does she love the dick?
Did you guys hear this?
Does she love the dick?
Well, you want to find out here?
Sure do.
Lady Gaga talks about her love life.
While Lady Gaga is as famous for her wardrobe as she is for her music, there's one accessory she's most certainly without.
Cock.
With no man in tow and rumors of bisexuality, the famed performer is downright clear on what she looks for in a partner.
Big dick.
And what else?
That's it.
That's it. So does that mean that any guy out here who thinks, hey, I got one of those, has a chance?
Yep.
So we're looking for a guy with large assets?
Oh, no, I'm not looking for anyone.
Are you happy just on your own? Are you seeing anybody at the moment?
I'm very happy with my solitude.
Yeah.
She likes big dick.
Yeah. I like that. I respect that.
Yeah.
Good girl.
Yeah. She's just trying to be a little shocking. Though,
yeah, it worked.
Well, of course.
I had a fucking drop leak out. Really, my dick just did like a little drool bubble. It was like this.
Why aren't there any naked Lady Gaga pictures from Playboy or something?
She wasn't in Playboy. That guy was completely wrong.
All right, wrong. Well, the guy was trying to help the show out.
I don't know about Lady Gaga like you do, Sam.
She was semi-nude on the cover of Rolling Stone, but she was covered with bubbles.
Yuck.
And she marriage
I wish it was Michael Jackson's bubbles and it was fucking ripping her tits off.
Biting her face.
Yeah, like that lady in Connecticut. She has no hands. She's Lady...
Yeah. Her tongue. Right.
Is marriage something that is important to you?
No. My art is the only thing that's important to me.
Do you want kids?
I think I would make quite a good mother, actually. I'm a very good friend, but I'm not, like, really excited to have kids or anything. I'm really enjoying traveling the world and sleeping with really good-looking people.
Where's she from there?
So outrageous.
She's from here.
I heard she's an NYU grad.
Yeah, she graduated from NYU School of Music. She's from here.
Oh, yeah, so she knows how to play the whole game.
Yeah.
That's what she's doing.
The Lady Gaga.
I wouldn't mind giving her backside a little kiss.
A little kissy?
There's something about her. I'll give her that.
Her fucking everything below the neck.
Yeah.
Her face is okay, too. I mean, I'd give her a smoocheroo.
She's average. She looks kind of like Courtney Love on the cover.
Yeah, she does.
Like a younger version of Courtney Love.
Younger, yeah.
You guys interested in listening to Spencer Pratt's rap song?
No. I actually would like to hear that.
We have to stop now.
No, I think I agree with Sam.
We really have to stop.
Spencer Pratt's rap song is probably really good.
Listeners have been saying it for 20 minutes, but I think they're right finally.
Probably really good.
It's time to sell them on Spencer Pratt, and this is the way we're going to do it today.
I don't disagree.
Who has it?
Steve, Mr. Steve C.
Yes.
And what's the rap song? Oh, hold on.
It's called I'm a Celebrity.
Yeah.
Hope he talks about some of the harder parts about being a celebrity, too.
Yeah.
Like the things that we don't get to see. Good so far.
On Air with Ryan Seacrest. Baby, I get paid. Swag on, Louis rag on, car with the new tags on. You know I
fucking die.
What?
Why? He's good. A superhero with working. I flew private in L.A. I'm back home through the Palisades, top down, get my tan on. I'm not you, I don't need the tattoos. All my ink is on my checks, the Rolex look like some president. I got a president wrist. Oh, the Rolex.
I want to apologize to the black man.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah. Really? That is a grave injustice to second to slavery.
What? No, no, no.
Second to slavery.
Black man should apologize to us for stealing all our fat blondes.
You're not a celebrity.
He's a super celebrity.
And is Lady he? Gaga, page 125 of the June issue of Playboy.
Whatever.
Naked?
Probably not.
On air with Ryan Seacrest. America hates because the media loves me. I'm so charged up they can't even unplug me. That's stop press.
Oh, really?
I'm
can't.
Hey. There you go. You've been unplugged.
Oops.
You know how famous that guy is?
Oh, wow. Okay, hold on.
Lady Gaga has a nice shitter.
Let's zoom in on Lady Gaga's ass.
She has a nice ass, huh? She sure does. Yeah, little pale cheeks.
Wearing fishnet stockings.
Not bad.
All right.
She's the best.
That ain't bad.
That ain't bad, Sam.
So pick up the CD, right?
No. I hate
her
music.
Too bad her asshole can't sing.
Yeah. What? But, I hate her music, but I'm kind of... I still can't figure it out.
Probably smells like a surf and turf.
Oh.
You fucking dirty crack.
God, I feel sweaty from doing a stage show. Just dripping down there from her fucking... between her shoulder blades all the way down to her knees.
Got some lint from her costume in it.
Yeah.
Like, if you lick her ass, you have to go... piece of fucking costume lint.
You guys want to hear a little more of the celebrity song?
Oh, yeah. I'd rather hear the sound of a bullet hitting me in the chest.
It gets really good right here. Everybody want a piece of my chicken. Southern fried chicken. Finger licking. Fried that chicken. Fried that chicken. Fried that chicken. You hear me?
No way. No way. What is this garbage?
What is this garbage? Garbage.
That wasn't
this
the song.
This is garbage. No way.
Matt from Buffalo. Even auto-tuning can't help this rap.
You don't need to auto-tune that rap.
What's up with the auto-tuning?
Jay-Z put out a new song last week. It's the death of auto-tune. It's over now.
Really?
Yep.
When Jay-Z says enough with the auto-tuning, that's it, right?
When the king says it, it's done.
Was he the first to do the auto-tuning?
Nope. But now it's over.
Auto-tuning makes everyone sound good.
And Jay-Z doesn't need
auto-tune. That's why Jamie Foxx has another hit on his hands, because of the auto-tuning.
How Jamie Foxx has... hits at all. He played fucking Ray, and then everybody took him all seriously as a singer.
We hate doing pop culture breaks, Sam.
Why?
Look how angry the room is.
I think
a lot of anger in here.
People should be abreast of what's going on.
Should they?
Yeah.
Jay-Z said, you know, enough with the auto-tuning.
It's his new single, Death of Auto-Tune. It's the greatest.
Why is it good?
Because he's the man. He's the god.
I like
Does
the 99 Problems.
In it? That would be funny.
Is that an old song now?
99 Problems is indeed an old song.
How old is that song? Because that one was good.
No, that came out many years ago.
Like, I actually liked that one a lot.
Well, yeah, it was a good song.
That's the only Jay-Z song I could name. Can you name a Jay-Z song? He's as big as they come, my friend.
Hova the God.
Who?
Hova the God.
No, I don't know that one.
That's not a song. I'm saying that's who he is.
Oh. And can you name a Jay-Z song?
Not one.
Why are we playing a new one?
I know that one.
Oh, Bonita Applebaum. That's one of the songs. It's an old rap. Bonita Applebaum. So fucking enraging.
All right, listen. I think we annoyed.
By the way, can I tell you whose fucking new stuff is really good?
Yeah.
Eminem's.
Mm. Oh, yeah? He's like it?
He's the only... There's certain criticism I'd have of him, but... he's the only fucking rapper that talks about being afraid. He's the only rapper that talks about fucking being, like, in emotional pain. Like, the rest of them, it's all about getting shot or having fucking possessions. But he talks about growing up, and there's one song he talks about being fucking molested.
It's all insane.
Do you have insane?
And his raps are all real. Like,
they're great,
He's not making up scenarios. He likes talking about his, oh, my God, every day with this one. Jesus Christ.
You don't have Insane?
Holy shit.
Why? It's a new album. How do we not have the whole new album? What are we, a bunch of queers?
For the audience, there's someone
I think
that
they just put the singles in the system.
For the audience, there's someone that walks around the facility that just doesn't believe in bras.
Yeah.
Right. These things just... she's got to be, like, bruising herself or something. You see those things bounce?
Player?
Maybe 20 years ago.
He's got it. He's got it.
My stepfather said that I sucked in the bed. So one night he snuck in and said, we're going out back. I want my dick sucked in the shed. Can't we just play with Teddy Ruxpin instead? After I fuck you in the butt, get some head, bust a nut, get some rest. The next day my mother said, I don't know what the fuck's up with this kid. The bastard won't even eat nothing, he's dead. He just hung himself in the bedroom, he's dead. Debbie, don't let that fucker get you upset. Go in there, stick a fucking cigarette to his neck. I bet you he's faking it, I bet you. I bet he probably just wants to see how upset you would get. I'll go handle this, of course, unless you object. I'll go fuck his brains out if any's left in his head. If you could count the skeletons in my closet, under my bed, no, under my faucet, then you would know I completely lost it. Is he nuts? No, he's insane. If you could count the skeletons in my closet, under my bed, no, under my faucet, then you would know I completely lost it. Is he nuts? No, he's insane. Dog, fuck, I tried to bite my face off. I just got fucking chased off with a chainsaw. Then he took the chainsaw, bit the fucking blades off. Ate the blades, stuck a baseball in a slingshot. Then he aimed at his own face, let the thing pop. Took his eye out, picked it up and played ping pong. Then he played ping pong with his own gang.
I would like the song if it wasn't about molestation. You think it happened to him, Jimmy?
I like it because it is.
Exactly. I don't know. I mean, his mother's name was Debbie, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that's what tells me that it's real, because the guy goes, Debbie, like that's a real... Probably, I mean...
Must have been quite the tussleable little kid,
too. Oh, sure. He's handsome as an adult.
Yeah, he's all about exaggerated truth, so elements of it.
Exaggerated?
Yeah. Well, that's
exaggerated. He's all about exaggerated truth.
There probably are elements of truth. And the song before that, he's called My Mom. He's got a really cool song about his mother being hooked on Valium. So I like the news. There's a couple of songs on here that are really fucking great.
He's
man.
A talented motherfucker.
He's a brilliant dude.
I think he went after Kim Kardashian, though. That's kind
of... Yeah. That's my only criticism of him, is he never goes after anybody. Like, you want to make fun of pop culture people, fine, but he never goes after anybody who's really...
Go after the homies.
Never, though.
Yeah, I know. Ooh. He knows they, you know, he owes them.
Footer, heard what we were saying about somebody here at SiriusXM. Footer?
Yeah, what's up, boys? Hey, it's a little distracting, though, but I know you keep getting fucking, you know, you keep looking up, and somebody's got to take care of those big tits flopping around that D-Rock needs to put a fucking bra on.
Oh, no, see?
Hey, Jimmy, I'm going to come see you down at the Palm Beach Improv, buddy.
Nice.
Oh, thank you. I'll be there the 19th and 20th. Ooh, the 18th, I'll be in Fort Lauderdale, so come see the show twice. It just gets better.
Footer rules. Look at us! Breitbart! Twice in 1 week.
Pre-park.
That's because we threatened.
Opie and Anthony exclusive. Brett Michaels, tour manager, confirms singer's injuries.
Nice.
You have to love Andrew Breitbart now.
Yes.
He's being very good to the show.
Did we get a little front page action there, Steve?
I still can't spell his fucking name, though.
I know. I don't know I before E except after what?
There's an E and an I and a T and an A and an R and a bunch of B's.
B-R-E-I-T-B-A-R-T.
Wow.
Wow. Front page for the boys today.
Top thing on the front page?
Let me hear. Click on that link. Let's listen to us and how good we are.
Watch it say Radio Hacks.
Radio shitheads. Opie and Anthony.
I hope I had something good to say during the Brett Michaels thing.
Yeah, you never know when we're going to be on Breitbart, Jimmy. Let's see if you did better this time. Brett Michaels, tour manager on the line, Pete. Hey, Pete, what's up, buddy?
What's going on, guys? So, hey, don't forget guitar player as well. Guitar player and tour manager.
Oh, fuck yeah. That's right. What's up, Pete?
How are you this wonderful morning?
Very good. We have to know what happened to Brett. We saw the clip from the Tony Awards.
Wait, misrepresenting us. We did not watch the Tony Awards, okay?
I said we saw the clip.
If we knew Brett was on it, maybe we would have watched the beginning of the Tonys, but we saw the clip this morning.
Right, it was the
we don't watch
minutes.
That stuff.
You could have gotten away with it in the first couple of minutes and still said you didn't watch the Tony Awards.
Yeah. Right.
All right, good.
So now,
on the same page.
What I saw was this. Let me know how accurate I was here. They're all playing. Brett decides... He's going to get that last bit of hay from the crowd. And as he turns to walk back, everyone else is already up on the riser, kind of behind this big piece of set that was coming down. And Brett, I think from his cowboy hat, didn't see the big piece of equipment and bam, smacked right into it with his head and hit the ground. Tell me what happened.
From watching it on YouTube and stuff, I imagine it's exactly what it looks like. But, you know, let's be honest with you. The entire thing was timed to a T. It was rehearsed and rehearsed again, and Brett's a pro with all that stuff. And that drop was falling a little bit ahead of time. It was falling faster than it should. And Brett had confidence that as many times as they'd walk through it that he'd be able to not get hit. And
well, how about he ducks?
He tried ducking when he realized, like, oh, fuck.
He went face first into that thing.
I mean, the cowboy hat definitely probably obstructed the view a little bit.
Yeah.
Again, they'd done it so many times, and it'd gone off flawlessly during rehearsals that he walked with confidence because the entire thing was timed to the music. Everything was timed perfectly.
Yeah, he did walk with confidence right into that thing.
So the curtain dropped. The curtain cue was dropping just a little earlier than it was supposed to.
So how is he doing? Did he get any injuries from that?
Yeah, man. Yeah, his nose is broke from what I understand.
Holy shit!
He's got some stitches and stuff. It cut his lip up and his nose pretty good.
God damn! Yeah, they cut right away from when it happened. They cut to some woman who was just kind of looking like, ooh.
Now, when you saw that, did you howl with laughter like we did?
I actually didn't see it. I was in the hotel across the street doing some business and stuff, and I got the call to come running over there.
Oh, okay.
So I probably saw it the same time you did on YouTube.
Yeah.
Why don't we get Brett on the phone today?
I guess he's out of town. Well,
all right. He's got a cell phone.
He's got
what
a cell
the
phone.
Fuck?
That's come true. On.
Brett, after he after the award show last night, he took his private jet and had to go to an undisclosed place after he got stitched up to take care of some other business. So I don't know. I don't
get
know
a whore.
On the phone today.
An abortion?
No, Jesus. He had to get it.
Hey, Pete's laughing. He went with it.
Oh, great.
All right. So who's pregnant?
Well, there's three or four of those Rock and Roll girls are pregnant right now, aren't they?
Wow. Damn.
From seasons 1, 2, and 3.
It's going to cost them a couple of bucks.
Yeah, well,
yes, sir.
We're glad
well, luckily he's got the money to spend. So.
Yeah.
We're glad he's okay. Only a broken nose. That's all right. And Jesus. And a lot of exposure today.
Face plant.
I think I would take a broken nose for a lot of exposure. I think you guys are happy. It's all over the place.
That's kind of the way he was at the end of it. You know, he you know, you laugh a little bit. I mean, he's been through motorcycle accidents and fights on stage. You know, Bob Dole threw the bass at him pretty hard a couple of years ago when he finished the set. So it takes a lot more than a steel backdrop to keep Brett Michaels down. So.
Brett Michaels walking into cubes.
Yeah, no way, no how. Hey, I got to tell you, do they still call him Behind the Music? Because Brett Michaels, Behind the Music, or whatever the hell they call him these days, one of the best ever.
You know what? E! Entertainment did the Brett Michaels True Hollywood Story.
Okay, right.
A couple months ago. And then, actually, in 2 weeks, they're doing, VH1 is going to air the new Brett Michaels Behind the Music, which is really cool because, really, you know, of artists that have gone solo, be it like Sammy Hagar or Vince Neil, this is the first time VH1's ever singled out the artist as opposed to the band they were originally with. So it's a big deal, and they're going to air it in a couple weeks.
Yeah, he's had a lot of stuff happen in his life.
You wouldn't believe it. There's
more stuff?
This is just the beginning of the rise of Brett Michaels. Next year, you're going to see some amazing things. The autobiography comes out, and the book is just killer. It tells everybody everything you've ever wanted to hear, all the without being raunchy and stupid. And I mean, it tells all the juice you'd ever want to hear, but it tells it in a very intelligent and fun way. So
cool.
Yep.
Well,
yep.
What else you want us to ask you, Pete? Jesus.
Just wanted to know how a Brett Schnozzola was.
Turned it into a 20-minute Brett Michaels commercial. I just want to know if he's okay, Pete.
I didn't ask for that. I was having a good time listening about the smart kid and his father.
Yeah, I hear you.
Well, we'll see you guys next time you're through New York, all right, Pete?
You got it, man. Thank you very much.
Yeah, right, man. And please tell Pete we say hey. And
Or Brett.
I mean, Brett. Sorry. It's Monday. And, yeah, tell him we said hey and all that.
You got it, man.
All right, Pete. Thank you.
Later.
Thank you.
Hey, that's pretty cool. We're back live. So, Breitbart, picking up our big exclusive.
Well, they're showing that all over the news. Every one of these news channels have that on today as their little funny clip from the Tony Awards.
Mm-hmm.
Brett Michaels running headlong into a giant piece of scenery.
Seems like a big, heavy piece of seems
yeah,
like
yeah,
so.
That had to hurt.
Well, we got a broken nose and stitches, what, cut lip and whatnot.
Whatnot.
And Breitbart picking up on it today. That's pretty cool. Breitbart.
.tv.
.tv.
And what did I say during that interview? I said,
you were good
did you howl?
Time,
and then I said, who's pregnant?
You got to assume that Breitbart's listening all the time now, Jimmy.
But I can't be fucking Pete Poignant all the time. I had
Poignant.
I don't want to be interrupting. Good point, Jim.
Pete Poignant.
No,
that doesn't work that way.
No,
anyway.
It certainly doesn't.
Ted Poignant, of course.
Of course. Teddy Poignant. But Ted's stupid. I'm Ted Poignant. You think this is French? Trying to be fancy.
Why don't we take a break and
yes,
we'll do a little wrap
I
it up next.
I need my chicken noodle soup.
Ooh, it's coming. Here it is, like right?
Throw
it
on oh, Kenny, you're
one
the man.
Moment. All right. Thanks, Sam. That was I hate pop culture.
I want that
breaks.
German chicken noodle soup.
After the guy fucks the chicken, he just stirs hot water with his dick, and then you eat it.
Yes.
Maybe that clip will make it to the web somewhere. Breitbart will say, Jim Norton talks about chicken fucking and dick stirring, and I'll come off brilliantly.
Dick stirring.
Mother's birth? Du
Hühnerflicker. Ja, irre. Ich bin ganz wild auf diese Hühner. Schwester.
Ja.
Ja. Ah, nun wird's gut. Ja, gleich. Ja.
Quit it now.
That chicken soup smells awesome.
It's so goodly.
Do you know how great, yeah. You know how much I'd love to stand over there and just fire a log into that before he gets 2 bites in?
I'd fish it out and eat it. That's how good this soup
how
is.
How fucking bad would it, like, as you're holding your soup, just a brown turd sticking up like a mighty silo.
I'd eat around it.
You would just push it to the side. Yeah, we all know that. Yes.
Wow, wow.
Wow, you guys are on fucking Fallon with Betty White.
Betty White.
That is unbelievable.
Betty White. And we're having her on the show, too.
What?
That's
She's funny, man.
She's great.
What was she funny in? Let me think. Uh-oh.
She was on fucking...
Mary Tyler Moore.
Mary Tyler Moore, yes. The Golden Girls.
She was on...
I didn't watch the Golden Girls.
Dude, it's one of the best shows ever.
You.
It's a great show.
See, you're not going to... Me and Ann hated it.
She was married to...
That's a funny show, man.
To the game show host there,
Gene...
From Password.
Oh. I was going to go Gene Rayburn.
No, the other guy.
From Password.
That was his name.
What?
Give me her... Give me Betty White's... Alan Ludden. Alan Ludden, she was married to.
Mm-hmm.
Not me. No way. Not once. Not never.
Not never.
Not never.
Fucking balloon hands.
CNN reports no broken nose. Uh-oh!
Well, that was, we got that right from,
Come on, right from the horse's mouth.
That's right. Apparently the other end.
Yeah.
I bet you Pete was just an intern down the hall.
Of course he was. Probably my agent, Pete. There's no idea.
Well, that's a little conflict there. Ooh, good.
Yeah, that could help us today.
That will.
My agent gives me the weirdest suggestions sometimes to come up with these crackpot ideas.
Like what?
Like last time when I was doing, the Tonight Show, I didn't really have, I wanted to promote something, and I'm like, let me promote the book, because they just asked me to do it before Jay left. I didn't ask, like, anything particular going on.
Right.
So I wanted to promote something. So I'm like, let me just plug the book again. And Pete goes, hey, how about this? You just go on, and you don't plug anything. I'm like, how about this? Shut up. There's fucking millions of people watching.
Yeah, how
why
about
would I not? What, that's not a big thing. Why would I do that? Your next act is promoting nothing?
Oh, my God.
At the least, you should be promoting your Twitter. Like, you have so many eyes on you. You got to promote something.
No, I wanted to promote the show.
Right.
And I wanted to promote my book.
Yeah, why would you do... Why would he come out with that harebrained idea?
That's a good... That's exactly what it was. A fucking harebrained idea.
Hey, Letterman goes after this Spencer kid. And everyone's saying it's worth playing today, even though we're trying to move on from the Spidey thing from earlier.
Excuse my interruption. Steve's pants, if you look at them when he comes back in.
Good, right?
They couldn't be gayer if they were soaked in cum before he put them on.
They may be.
Worse than the capris?
They make the capris look like fucking, look like football pants.
Come on, really?
Dude, that's just...
I didn't even notice. Now I gotta look.
They're fucking terrible.
I know. Now I gotta look.
E-Rock, Spencer from the Hill. So he was on Letterman, and what do you got? You're saying it's good too, huh?
Yeah, Spencer has nothing to say. He's so boring. And Letterman just spends the whole interview just destroying him.
Live interview, right in front of his face.
Live, yep. And his girlfriend is in the green room, too. It got so bad that he decided to go talk to her in the green room.
That's wonderful. It is great when, like, some of these dopey fucking celebrities that have nothing to say are called out like that. Instead of the host having to go, like,
here's for Letterman.
Come up with something. Good.
On the show, you're a dope. Are you really in real life?
So is he talking about this celebrity thing? Get me the fuck out of here,
No, this is long before. I think this is about a year ago.
Okay. God bless Letterman for doing this.
Now, how do you do that? Because I'm sure you're not the first person to whom that has occurred. I'd like to be on that show. So how do you actually make that happen? How'd you get on this show, for a matter of fact?
Oh, shit. Oh, damn. He's fucking him up.
Is he great?
Now you I understand you get fees to actually go to a nightclub. Like, if somebody wanted you to go to a nightclub, they would pay you, right?
Minimum $100,000.
Wow. For a second there. I thought you said $100,000.
I did.
No, seriously, what are they?
Seriously, I won't go to a club now for less than $100,000.
You know, neither will I. Neither will I.
Nobody has given you. Nobody has given you $100,000 to leave the house.
Wow.
God, what a douchebag he sounds like, right?
Yeah.
Fucking cocky asshole.
What are you gonna do for $100,000 at a party? Shut up at a club.
That's one of those things.
Like, sack of shit.
They'll pay you $20,000 to go.
They're paying like some of these people a lot of money just to show up.
What a fucking.
Just to say that they.
No, who makes a lot of money is that Paris Hilton.
Yes, she does.
She makes a lot of money just going around the world, showing up at clubs. And finally, Heidi's in the green room.
Green room, I understand. Heidi, hi, Heidi.
Hi,
how are you?
How
do you think it's going so far?
I think really well. Spencer's the man.
For what? Well, I wish you were out here instead of Spencer. But,
Fucking Letterman, man, he in that seat is invincible.
Yeah, very.
Him and O'Reilly went back and forth. And O'Reilly, like him or hate him, is not a dummy. And Letterman fucking really kicked him around.
Mm-hmm.
Ugh, this Spencer even looks like a jizz bucket.
And he's from, what show is it?
It's Brian Seitzer hair.
He's on that show, The Hills. He's friends with...
The Hills.
Brody Jenner.
I have no idea what names you're saying.
Wait, did you just have an aneurysm?
What?
We were talking about The Hills.
No, I know. I'm just saying, is that the guy?
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
oh.
We were just talking about it during that conversation that I could not give a flying fuck about.
All right,
so
I was scared.
Like, is that the guy from The Hills?
Okay, all right,
or was it another guy on the show?
Hey, what's up with our online feed? 202's not coming in. Every other channel's coming in except ours, and everyone's lit out there.
Yeah, that's nice.
And some feedback is lit with people going, what the hell?
Steve, can you show them your
I'm
still not getting
here,
your broadcast, guys. XM Online not broadcasting you, guys, since you went to break. You guys are not online right now. I guess the online feed is really, really a big deal for our show.
Ew.
Steve, can I see your pants?
Oh, sure.
Oof.
I've seen assless chaps that scream to masculinity more than those do. I don't dislike them.
Steve, what are you doing?
They got flowers on them.
You should be.
My arms have flowers tattooed on them too.
You're wearing fucking girl country line dancing pants.
No, I'm not.
Sure. Those are chick.
Oh my god.
Those are chicken and cowboy hat pants.
They're not.
You should be singing "Stand by Your Man" as guys jerk off on your forehead.
You got to be really.
This on crackers. Make a circle.
You got to be brave to have roses on your jeans, Steve.
Well, I got them tattooed, but I have flowers tattooed on my arms. I mean, I can take the jeans off for crying out loud.
In the right company.
Wow.
All right, the online feed is back, so that's good.
Okay, they fixed
it. It was only off for a second.
No, it's cool. I didn't realize how many people are listening online.
I know a lot of people.
Everything just went batty.
Do a lot of people listening to the show online.
At work, right? People at work?
Yeah, it's good to know.
Certainly are.
What's going on with SiriusXM and Apple? Do we know anything? I'm hearing like little rumors and...
I have not heard a thing.
Just
I
swirling.
I haven't heard a goddamn thing.
Just want to know if there's any truth to the swirling rumors.
Swirling? Are they literally...
What, is Sirius going to start a phone service that's better than AT&T? I'm sure they could.
We'll have to wait and see.
You are such a negative little Nelly about
I'm not
AT&T.
Negative, dude. I'm just one of these ignorant people that does... AT&T is the best phone service for people who are maintaining eye contact. Like, if you're within a stone's throw, there's no one better. But if something should happen, like a fly should zip in between your signal.
Oh, yeah, then it'll interrupt a little bit.
What's this Derek thing? I hear this is terrific, huh?
Derek seems to have, if you remember, we were somehow parodying the fact that I might want to have gotten my diploma years ago and that there should be a TV show about me going back to school to get my diploma. And Jimmy... just started making up, like, the theme song to it.
Yes, I did.
And Derek took that little nugget of thought and made this.
Oh, he's older than the teachers, and he makes more money than the whole school. He's an alcoholic. He's Anthony. He's the oldest kid in class. He gets them drugs and fucks their heinies. His big, delicious cock should be black. It's not. He's Anthony. Oh, he carries a trapper keeper full of Hitler photographs. He's Anthony. He's Anthony. He tries to be everyone's friend, but he gives all the girls the creeps. They think he's somebody's father who just showed up for no reason. He's Anthony. He's Anthony.
Fantastic. It goes to the music so nicely.
And then the school bell.
Oh, of course.
Time for school.
Oh, Derek. Very good.
Yeah, Derek's good.
That's great.
Doing a great job with it.
And they show you in the gym alone with a walker waving your fist.
Waving my fist at the kids.
An empty gymnasium.
I'm late for class again.
They take you down to the gym to fucking murder you, like in No Way Out, when they want to shoot that wheelchair fucking Budinski, and they fucking kill him in the basement.
I don't think that's only one episode. I want this thing to go a couple of years.
Who could play the principal? Who would play the principal who's like your nemesis?
Oh, yeah, because you got to have one of those.
Oh, I want Gordon Clapp to play it, and then...
From WKRP?
Yes, and then every week... After you're paralyzed, he puts you in a tub and tries to molest you like Dudley. He rubs chocolate sauce on you and tries to molest you.
We have time for one more?
Room for one more, honey.
One more?
Room for one more, honey. Very scary Twilight Zone.
Well, a lot of people saying that the feed is down.
That means it's good, right? Yo, that feed is down.
No? You guys aren't coming in on XM Online. It's good to know a lot of people listen to that online thing. Oof. They're telling us to get off the air in a few minutes so they could fix it.
Well.
Thumbs up, Mars? Oh, man, come on. We had a few more things we want to do today.
Well.
Should we squeeze this one thing in?
Yeah.
Might as well.
All right, one more thing. Is that right, Mars?
Yeah. He's nodding his head, yes.
Police were called to the 38th Street and Washington Station because of a man on board playing with feces.
That's disgusting.
Playing.
See, this is why.
Is it playing when it's feces?
See, this is why you got to allow, violent video games, or you're going to have this all over the place. People are going to be so bored.
Is it playing with feces, though? Because, like, it becomes a whole nother thing.
I think it's, What do you think it is?
I don't know, because you're not playing with it.
Toying.
Toying?
Manhandling feces.
Or handling. Yes. Handling feces.
Fiddling about.
Something. it's like...
Twiddling feces.
You're not playing with feces.
Let me think that.
It depends on what he was doing, Ant.
Because it's so sick that the word playing doesn't even fit.
Man, put a pile of feces in front of you, imaginary pile, and like... What is it? Like, you're kind of...
Now, you can handle it. You're handling feces.
Kind of fooling around with feces, I'll call it.
You're jockeying with feces.
Ah! Online feed is dead. Online feed is down.
You're kidding!
All right. We got to get the feces story.
That's nasty.
The girls pretty much summed it up.
police were told the man who was on board the train was flicking or smearing feces, which he had with him.
That's so nasty.
It was 8 in the morning, the middle of rush hour. Passengers who did what they could to get away were allowed to get off the train at 38th Street in Washington. Other riders can't imagine being in that situation.
I would move and change to another seat. Just run off the light rail.
Really?
Wow.
Really? You would move your seat? Really?
If someone's flicking shit at me, I think I'd move.
Yeah.
Wow. You're a crazy woman.
Just run off the light rail. I don't even care if it was moving.
I would obviously move from the area of the feces.
Really, would
and
you?
Make sure I tell the correct authorities about the situation.
The train operator was notified, and light rail quickly took the train out of service.
It's a biohazard, and we have protocols for how we handle situations like this.
Those protocols include disinfecting the train. Even though this is very bizarre, light rail anticipates everything.
The metro is a public space. What happens potentially in a park could also have the potential to happen on board.
The man who police say is homeless was questioned at the station and eventually released.
Why was he released if he was throwing shit around on a train?
They just don't hold anybody for shit unless it's murder.
For shit, literally.
For rape. For shit. Like, if you do a real crime, but they don't hold people. And then this guy will do something crazy and then just chop someone up. And they'll be like, well, boy, they had him. I don't understand why this guy wasn't held longer for something. There's no rooms in the jails anymore.
Oh, I understand that today is someone's birthday.
Happy.
Oh.
Where is he?
Mars.
Is it?
It's Mars'
Mars
birthday?
Is his birthday.
But he's got to take care of the online feed.
Cool.
I'll do this.
That's
for
probably
him.
How it crashed.
We'll do this for him.
Thank you. Thank you, all dear friends, for coming to my birthday. Ah!
The great thing is you could hear him talking over those fake teeth.
Mm-hmm. For coming to my birthday.
Look, he's got a major problem on his birthday. We
Mars
leave.
Doesn't get a cake.
How great would it be if he was fired on his birthday?
Oh, guy.
Oh, Ted Kennedy is still around. Jesus.
That's there not. That's not. Is that no,
that's
a recent
gotta be
picture?
Old footage.
Come on. Oh,
come on.
Yeah, that he looked
yeah,
showing people. Too spry.
Kennedy's health care plan. Oh, I'm sure. Yeah, politicians with fucking pudding head get free medical care. No.
It's a problem in D.C.
I just thought it was like, you know, some knowledge.
Yeah, I hear Obama is going to tax the wealthy a little more to get health care through also for every person.
Schwarzenegger's talking Thank about you. A 15% flat tax.
Flat tax.
Like that's getting spoken about now by people again.
That'd be fantastic, but it ain't going to happen with a fucking
know why that's not fantastic?
Piece of shit Democrat Congress and everybody. It just won't happen.
Because you turn that 15 into 17 into 20 into 20, you know.
And then everybody's paying
oh,
through
my
the nose.
Oh, God. I just want to get to the finish line in one piece.
Yeah, right. Yep.
Why don't we
get to that finish line? All right, everybody. Well, I think we had fun today.
Yeah,
I sure
so.
Did.
I'm going to go home and fire out a Duke.
Are you?
Yep.
Little duties.
I don't even have to. I just want to.
Big fat duty.
Hopefully. Nice sideways one like a football.
Ooh.
Those hurt. Those
I love.
Hurt. Those hurt coming out.
Those I like, hurt midway through.
I like to I like to take a dump where each side of my ass wall has a red mark on it.
Let's get out of here. See you tomorrow.
Later, man.